Gras.
It's the best party in town.
Do you have a place to pee? It's very important.
There ain't no reason you and me should be alone tonight. Yeah, baby, tonight. Yeah, baby. I got a reason that you who should take me home tonight.
I haven't planned that out. Do I need to bring, like, a bucket? Do I need to use my bucket?
Quite possibly. Or just find, like, a nice alleyway.
How are you celebrating Mardi Gras tonight?
I'm going to work in the emergency department.
So no partying at all?
I don't want to see either of you there.
We're not planning it, but it may happen.
Is this a busy night for you, or?
The gays can look after themselves. They're pretty good.
Right. Awesome.
What have you been doing so far?
I got into a drag competition on Monday night.
Did you win?
No, I came third.
What's your drag name?
Carmen Slider.
Nice.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah,
you get it?
Yeah.
Takes about 5 seconds, but you got there in the end. What do you like about Mardi Gras the best? Why do you keep coming back, baby?
You know what? We were talking about it yesterday. It honestly feels like a high school reunion.
So what's your name?
My name's Fantasia Towers.
Cool, and...
just to let Melbourne know, I'm a drag queen.
She looks stunning. Dying.
Oh, thank you.
She's in day drag.
Yeah, day drag. Cool. And I'm in the parade tonight. So.
What are you doing in the parade?
I'm on the Tropical Fruits in the Northern Rivers, Lismore, on the float there. So it'll be interesting.
Beautiful. And then what's your plan for after?
After our party. Party hard.
Yay,
party hard.
Everybody's going.
Yes, that's what everyone's doing. Might as well join the rest of them.
Now tell me, what do you like best about Mardi Gras?
What I like best, you can be yourself. You can be yourself, be who you really are. Doesn't matter if you're gay, straight, anyone.
What do you love about it?
Oh, glitter. Love glitter.
Yes, everybody loves the glitter.
Yeah, you know, love glitter, love dancing. And, you know, it's a, as you said, you know, it's a way to be yourself. So, yeah, I love it.
Are you together?
No. We've been together for 10 years as best mates.
Oh, beautiful. Oh,
beautiful.
And so tell me, what do you love most about Mardi Gras?
I think just the love that's going around.
It's always a good party.
Yeah, so much bad stuff happening in the world these days, but just to have one night of, you know, love, can't beat it.
Do you have a favourite float?
I think the Lifesavers
got to be up there. Yeah. What do you like about them? I couldn't think.
Oh, just Aussie icons, aren't they?
Yeah, exactly. Are you guys straight?
Yes.
How about, thank you.
We found the only two straight people on Oxford Street.
I am now shopping for a last minute top for my hula hoop float in the parade tonight.
Oh my God, you're in the parade.
Yes, indeed. It's very exciting.
A hula hoop top. Explain that.
Oh, well, I'm hula hooping in Hoop Force Australia's Mardi Gras float. And I need a pink top to go with my fairy floss headdress because our theme is Sugar Rush. It's a candy float.
Oh, my God.
My God, I can't wait.
It's going to be so good.
It's queer Christmas.
Big party. I'm from Romania and I come here just for gay party.
Yeah.
Oh, we love Melbourne. Yeah, hi.
Easy questions. What's your name?
Eugene.
Eugene or my Jane?
Oh, anything you want.
Oh.
You're from New Zealand?
Yeah, you're New Zealand.
Did you come here just for Mardi Gras?
Yeah, every year.
What keeps you coming back?
Friends and the party.
Why are you walking down Oxford Street today?
I'm actually looking for glitter and a spray tan.
Nice. At the same time?
Not at the same time, separately.
I don't know where I'm going for it. I did just wake up. I went and saw Sophie Ellis-Bextor last
night. So did we!
She was amazing.
I'm here with my husband. We got married at the British Consulate last November.
Beautiful, congratulations.
And we've been together 35 years. And so, you know, it does last. Mm. And we love coming up to Mardi Gras, and it's just so much fun. It's such a lovely feeling, a friendly feeling, an inclusive feeling. People from all walks of life, different age groups, and that's what we love. It's such a festival.
Aww.
And it's so much fun.
Thinking you're the only gay in the village.
And what's your favourite thing about Mardi Gras?
Everybody's friendly. They're not as bitchy as they usually are. Like,
you're so right.
Not as judging.
Yes.
So we're here at Mardi Gras. Everybody just loves everybody. So.
Did you say love was in the air?
Every time
I look around.
In more corners than others. I'm actually in the parade this year with Department of Transport.
Nice.
And it's massive. And so this year we're doing vintage pin-up.
What's like your ultimate getting ready song?
Probably Peaches. Yeah, I want to take you downtown. Or Kick It.
Love it, love it.
Where are you from?
Glasgow.
Glasgow!
Just like the world is ours.
I'll say Carly Burleys. I'll say there's been a murder.
There's been a murder!
I am done. That's Mardi Gras made for me.
We are working today
for the official merchandisers of Mardi Gras. This year's symbol is the Infinity Love Heart. We have lots of lovely lasses, bow ties, face paints. Can I undress you gentlemen in some face paints?
Oh, no. We won't be buying anything, baby. We're stingy.
That's okay. I will donate.
We're poor.
Some face paints to you.
Are you donating?
Oh, my God.
Oh, thank you. A free perk. It's my first free perk.
Yes.
Yes. Are you together?
Yes.
How dare you not be a homosexual?
I know.
Half a broken. This is why I asked him to come and work with me today, because he...
To watch him.
He goes down very well.
What are your plans for Mardi Gras Day?
Just coming here party. And... Just join the parade, and we're from Brisbane.
From
so.
Brisbane.
Yeah. Oh, we have an apartment up there. We're on the
corner. Lucky for nice. Some.
You can come and join us.
Okay, we'll join.
Thank you.
Are you from Sydney?
Yeah.
Great answer.
Good answer.
Tell me more about that.
What do you love about Mardi Gras?
Everyone's so happy and friendly and everyone having a good time.
Are you from Glasgow as well?
No, I'm from Ireland. Oh. I don't like it when people think I'm Scottish.
We are here for Mardi Gras.
Is it your first Mardi Gras? Or?
It is. It is the first one.
Are you enjoying it so far?
So far, so good. Looking forward to a good night.
Okay.
What do you love most about Mardi Gras?
Just the vibrancy, just the colourful characters, the party, everything.
Yeah. Are you celebrating Mardi Gras?
Yes.
You look amazing, by the way.
Thank you.
This harness. Love it.
This is a thing from Honey Burdette, and I like it, so why not?
It's not simple. Is this your first Mardi Gras?
Yes, I've never been to a Mardi Gras.
What do you think of the vibe? Like, explain
it. So much. I'm excited. I just walked into a sex shop. I'm very excited, guys.
What's, like, your ultimate getting ready jam to listen to get you in the mood?
Well, for Mardi Gras, it had to be RuPaul.
Hell yeah.
And Sissy That Wall.
Love it. Tonight we're going hard. Have you been to Mardi Gras before?
In 2000.
Okay. Oh, wow. So like 16 years ago.
Yeah, I was 25, yeah.
Jesus. Thanks for telling us how old you are. Let's do the math. 25 plus 16.
Yeah.
You do not look 41, by the way, babe.
Thank you very much.
Wow, yeah. You're so good at math. What's your favourite thing about Mardi Gras?
Just being free, all the colour.
Yes.
And people not holding back and being who they are.
From Sydney's Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras 2016, coming to you from Taylor Square, right in the heart of Oxford Street. Big thank you to Dan for that wonderful package of Fox Pops. Shannon Power is with me, and we are witnessing the prelude.
Australia's most amazing gay and lesbian radio station, Joy 94.9.
Hello, this is Julia Zemiro.
Hi, this is James Rand.
Hi, this is Cameron Datto.
Hi, this is Beck Krumer.
Hey, this is the Potbellies.
Hi, this is Roger Sanchez.
Hi, this is Tina Cousins.
Hey, what's up? This is Jack from Fun.
Hi, this is Casey Donovan.
Hi, hello there.
Hi, this is Frank Woodley.
This is Pete Evans from My Kitchen Rules.
Hi, my name is Stephen K. Amos.
Hey there, I'm Adam Lambert.
Hi, this is Monique Martina.
Hello, this is Zoe Bagley.
Hi, I'm Cindy Lauper, and if you just want to have fun, do you? Keep listening to Joy 94.9.
Hello, I'm Peter Hitchener from Nine News.
Joy.
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 Joy. Joy. Joy.
G'day, I'm Barry Bissell, and you're listening to Australia's first and only gay and lesbian radio station, the mighty Joy 94.9.
Joy. 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 94.9.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Your little girl is your princess, and her room is her castle.
Hi, I'm Rick from Happy Tin. Every princess needs privacy from eyes outside. Happy Tin adds a protective shield of privacy to your castle windows, without the need to draw curtains, close blinds, or heave up the drawbridge.
Happy Tint your princess to safety.
Happy Tint your home, your office, your car. Call 1-800-HAPPY-TINT.
Visit happytint.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
Chapel Street is bringing the party to the back streets as part of Melbourne Food and Wine Festival. Grab your friends and join us for a Sunday session in celebration of Melbourne's best urban street food with party vibe tunes, street art, circus arts and hip hops and drops. This free event, proudly supported by Deliveroo, takes place on Sunday, March 6th from 1 till 9pm in the Artist's Lane between Green and Union Streets. Then kick on after the party from 8 till late at Hoo Ha. For full lineup, visit chapelstreet.com.au. The Windsor & Co. Block Party, presented by the Chapel Street Precinct, a Joy sponsor.
The Lost Dogs Home on Joy 94.9 presents Pets Allowed. Join the Lost Dogs Home crew and friends for Pets Allowed, exploring all things animal from wet nose to wagging tail. Fridays from noon on Joy. News, views, interviews, advice and everything mice. Brought to you by Joy sponsor, The Lost Dogs Home. Pets Allowed on Joy. More fun than you can wag your tail at.
Are you looking for double the fun, double the action and double the men on the Mornington Peninsula? Then check out the adult entertainment jewel of Seaford, Peninsula Sauna, the hottest place down south for meeting other gay and bisexual guys. Open every day from midday till late with the best place to cruise, relax, meet and play. Featuring two spas, two movie lounges, twice the cruise rooms, dry sauna, steam room and more. With a licensed bar and cafe, masseurs on site, free Wi-Fi and computer use. Check out the special theme nights and more details at peninsulasauna.com.au. Joy sponsor.
From the outrageously adorned to the sassy, satirical and serious, SBS is showcasing the truly incredible 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Hosted by Patrick Abood, Faustina Agoli, Tom Ballard and Magda Szybanski. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Tomorrow 8:30 on SBS. Reflecting diversity.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Live from Taylor Square here in Sydney, the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Dean Beck and Shannon Power with you. And before our very eyes, we see our Prime Minister on Oxford Street doing selfies.
He's moved up from the balcony at the pub down to prime position seating at the corner of Taylor Square.
He's on the road.
He's pretty much, you know what, he might even jump over the fence and into the parade. Who knows what good old Malcolm will do. Now, we are broadcasting live around the world on Joy 94.9, but we do have a committed team of social media experts at our studios in Melbourne. Katie Purvis, Leo Stubbing, and Daniel Kilby doing Facebook at Joy949, Twitter at Joy949, Instagram at Joy949. And we have a mission tonight, not to only have the best Mardi Gras ever, but we want our hashtag trending, and that is hashtag Mardi Gras Joy. Get it trending, people. Start using it. We want to see us up there as a worldwide trend. So if you want to follow the action, not just by listening to our dulcet tones, you can also jump onto social media on all those different platforms. Follow us at Joy949. And what's the hashtag? Mardi Gras Joy.
Hashtag Mardi Gras Joy.
How easy could it be?
Yesterday, I caught up with the global ambassador of Mardi Gras. It is the very gorgeous Courtney Act.
I love her.
And this is what she had to say. Courtney Act, just give me, how many of these have you been to, Courtney?
I lost count. I've been coming since the year 2001. I think I may have missed one or two.
How many have you performed at?
Oh, well, my first one was 2002. It was the 4 a.m. show, and my mum and dad came. And, well, Mardi Gras is not really somewhere that you want your mum and dad at 4 a.m. And my dad looks like a lost member of the Village People. So I was a little bit worried about some leather queen touching up my dad on the dance floor. Or worse yet, my dad touching up some leather queen on the dance floor.
Now, you have gone from strength to strength since those early days. What are we expecting from you this time around?
Well, on the parade, I'm very excited. I've just come from the Opera House doing our Gentlemen Prefer Bloke show, and I'm about to get on a giant phallus and hurtle up Oxford Street. It's the Qantas Gay380.
Wow, wings and all.
Wings and all. Oh, are there wings? I don't know. I haven't seen it this year
yet. Might take out a few heads on the way through.
Yeah. Not a real A380. Okay. That's what I wanted. I was like, just drive an A380 up Oxford Street, guys. And they're like, well, it's a little bit wider than the street clearance, so.
And later tonight, can we expect anything big from you?
Yes.
Can we talk about that?
Yeah, the 1:30 a.m. show. I'm looking forward to it with 50 Sydney drag queens and Conchita Wurst. It's going to be pretty fun.
Wow. I mean, the comparison of herding cats is one thing, but 50 drag queens?
It's like trying to pin a wig on a wet cat. But I think that any Mardi Gras where there are 50 drag queens in drag released into the wild after their show at 1:30, that is a recipe for a good time / disaster.
Hopefully we can get cleaned up here enough in time to make that show. Courtney Act, chookers for tonight.
Thanks, chookers. Happy Mardi Gras.
She must be doing something right. She's been the global ambassador of the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras for 3 years running.
And living in the US for the last 5 years.
Yeah, good on her. You're just trying to show you know more about Courtney Act than me. Pretty Is that what you're doing, Dean Beck?
Dean Beck and Shannon Power with you here live from Taylor Square as we bring you the colour and movement of the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Now, let's have a listen to what they have to say in the pit. What are we going to call that? The pit. All right. Well, down in the pit, we have Scott, Josh, Grace and Dylan. Let's go to Scott.
Hello. Yes, we are in a pit. We're in the cage. It's a cage and it's a pit. And very happy down here on the streets in Sydney for Joy 94.9. So colourful. The dykes on bikes were amazing, weren't they, Dylan?
That's right, Scotty. It was pretty cool seeing them go past. Although I have to say the dykes on bikes have absolutely owned it so far. I mean, the boys on bikes, pretty cool seeing us going to see some guys on the bikes. But when the lovely dykes on bikes went past and the hogs, I mean, you got some really cool, nice sounds coming from those motorcycles.
That you could feel the vibrations.
Oh, absolutely. And I swear, like, some of those bigger hogs, they just seem to make the sports bikes seem pale in comparison.
What I loved, not only were all the bikes also black, right, but then all the colour, and I saw the Star Wars. How cool was the Star Wars?
We did see a stormtrooper of the dykes on bikes. But I have to say, I'm loving the Mohawks that we're seeing so far. There's some of them are giving me a bit of a run for my money, I have to say that, Scotty.
Yeah, so how many more minutes is it to go before we start?
Oh, it's not too far off now, but I'm quite keen to be seeing what's going on tonight. And with such lovely hosts up on the decks, too.
It's back to you, Shannon and Dean.
Thank you very much.
All right, you are listening to Joy 94.9. We're streaming live from the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras at Taylor Square. Dean Beck, Shannon Power, thank you to Scott and Dylan. They're right down in the thick of it. We're up here in our privileged ivory tower looking down on the masses. And as we are speaking, the Dykes on Bikes are making another come up Oxford Street. We just can't get rid of them.
Certainly are. They're doing their main run through. But Shannon, earlier I went down to the Harmony Park and I had a chat to one of the groups that's been participating in this for quite some years, the Glamazon All Stars. I'm down at Harmony Park where the Glamazon All-Stars have been assembling and getting themselves together. I'm with Brendan and Hayley. Thank you for joining us. Brendan, tell us a little about your group. It's been around a while now.
Yeah, so we've been around since 2012 and we love getting involved in Mardi Gras and we always march with a passion, with a cause and with some great core values that really resonate with the entire Glamazon crew.
Hayley, what is this year's theme for you guys?
This year's theme is the Glamazon Cadet Corps. I was traveling overseas for quite a bit last year, and while what we've got in Australia is worth celebrating, what we have both here and internationally is also worth still fighting for. So this year we've put together a little band of marchers, a little tribe of 100 instead of 160, which is our usual plot.
Uh-huh.
But this year's themes are marching for truth, for justice and for hope.
What a beautiful theme. Now, is that why you've been stuck side by side with the the Surrey Hills Police Station to keep you on track and true to your cause?
Just the best mark and best stage.
I think we need to keep them in track, really. But, I mean, it's fantastic that, you know, both them and the state government came out today and apologised to the 78ers. And so did, I believe, the Herald also apologised as well. I think that's really fantastic that they've acknowledge their wrongdoing in 78. I think it's a great step forward and what a year to celebrate it now, especially with our theme.
Hayley, how do you go about recruiting your marchers each year?
Given that we've been running since 2012, formally and informally since, mid-2000s, it's actually not that hard. The hardest thing is actually trying to fit everybody in. This year, Mardi Gras introduced a cap to the larger floats so that we can have more diversity within the parade itself. So this is two-thirds of the compliment that you would usually see. Our float last year was 164 marches.
Well, we will be waving to the blue and gold, the Glamazon All-Stars, as they go past tonight. Good luck and have a happy Mardi Gras.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
The Glamazon All-Stars, they were down rehearsing and getting ready for tonight. They looked spectacular, Shannon Powell.
Yes, we're here at Taylor Square.
Can you hear that?
Well, I think I need to speak a little bit louder because I think the parade has officially begun. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras parade has kicked off. The Dykes on Bikes. Look at them. I mean, we can barely hear ourselves. We may as well just turn our mics off and let them head on through. They look great, though.
The Dykes on Bikes were founded in 1988 and they took part in the parade for the first time that year. They're a community organisation that are dedicated to the provision of a safe place for women to ride and socialise together. And they're famous for their fundraising.
They are. They do fantastic work, the Dykes on Bikes, and it looks like they're definitely in a safe place tonight. And the beautiful thing about Mardi Gras is we can see not only rainbow flag and transgender flags, but we saw a Tibetan flag and we saw flags for a whole range of issues, which is what a lot of the essence of Mardi Gras is. It's not just about fighting for marriage equality. It's about the justice for all different groups. And it's great to see that this isn't just about shiny glitter. It is about social issues as
well. I've got to share a little story with you. Yesterday when I was down in the shopping centre, one of those little Chinese $2 type shops was chock-a-block full with straight backpackers boys buying anything and everything that remotely looked like a rainbow. And they were like taking it out in bucket loads. Rainbows are the thing.
Now, Dean Beck, you've been coming to Mardi Gras for quite a few years now, and I imagine seeing that sort of thing where there's a lot more sort of straight mainstream people buying up all the rainbow flags on Oxford Street. Has that changed? Was that always the case from like back in black and white days when you're coming to Mardi Gras?
I think the change is in the participation. The fact that they buy a rainbow flag for me is them actively participating. Back in the day, in the 90s, when I first started coming, I think it was more they'd come to sort of look out at the freak show, you know?
Right.
And I think these days they're very much on board and they're supporting us. And wearing a rainbow rainbow flag is their way of saying how.
And do you know what's really fantastic? That the streets here are absolutely jam-packed in Darlinghurst in Sydney, which is the home of Oxford Street, the main gay strip here in Sydney. There's over 175 floats participating in this year's Mardi Gras parade, but one of my favourite statistics is there's over, is it 200 kilos of glitter being
260
used?
260 kilos of glitter has been used. That's with just the official floats.
Right.
And much, much more with the...
I feel like most of that is on me. I glittered up. My house is a glitter bomb. But that's what Mardi Gras is about. It's if you didn't put my glitter on yourself, you'll end up on it with this somehow.
I must say, we are in the privileged position of being able to witness the footage that SBS are shooting for their special. And the imagery is extraordinary. They've got segways, those funny little stand-up things with cameramen on them. They've got booms shooting right across Oxford Street. The photography, the cinematography is spectacular.
Oh, I see the segway. So there's a guy with the camera on a segway filming. All right, so tomorrow night, 8:30 on SBS, tune in because you're just going to see something. But if you are listening online and you want to see what the visuals are like, you can watch online by the mardigras.org.au website. You can also listen to us telling you what's going on, but this is every colour of the rainbow, no pun intended. There's so much going on here at the Mardi Gras Parade.
You are listening to the Joy 94.9 SBS Digital Radio 3 coverage of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Now, earlier today, just before we started all of this off, I went back down to Harmony Park and I spoke to Bryce. He's from the Asian Marching Boys and Friends. Well, I've moved a little along further in the park and I'm with Bryce. He's with the Asian Marching Boys and Friends.
Yeah.
What an interesting name. Tell us about the organisation. How many people have you got with you?
It's been going for about 20 years and I've been doing it for 11 and we have 64 people marching this year and we're a golden army. So
you certainly are a golden army. Absolutely resplendent in gold, and you've got an amazing headdress on. How is that staying on?
Oh, just holding up. We were inspired by the movie The Curse of the Golden Flower, which is the highest grossing Chinese film ever made. So we wanted to go back to our roots and have a very traditional Asian theme, oriental.
And I guess it's all about diversity here at Mardi Gras, and you're very much a part of that.
It is. Our group is for anybody to join any culture, colour, and it's about blending the cultures together.
Bryce, thank you very much for joining us, and have a happy Mardi Gras.
Thank you. Happy Mardi Gras.
Dean Beck and Shannon Power with you here at the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Shannon, when the bikes went past, something happened before our very eyes.
Now, Sydney was the site, this very square that we're standing in was the site of the very first ever rainbow crossing set up by James Brecco, can't remember his last name, he's on the committee of Mardi Gras now.
And then they took it away.
Then they took it away, but you know what they've done for tonight? They've rolled out another rainbow crossing right here on Taylor Square. And of course, if you remember that, James set up the rainbow crossing here in Taylor Square. It took off as a global phenomenon. It went viral. People all around the world were putting out rainbow crossings. So I think this is great that the rainbow crossing started here in Sydney. We've got another one tonight for the Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Fantastic.
Certainly, and it only lasts today and then it disappears. I've heard this particular night referred to as Gay Christmas.
Oh, absolutely, it's Gay Christmas. I went all out with my outfits, with my hair. Maybe the wind has done something different to my hair now, but
well,
you know.
It was camp as Christmas, I'll give you that much. Now, earlier today, the police gave us a little chat as to what they were expecting from tonight, and Superintendent Tony
Crandell
had this to say.
I'm with Inspector Gemini Bakos with the New South Wales Police. You have marched with the GLOWs in Mardi Gras quite a few times, I believe.
I have. I've actually been a GLOW since 1995, and I've marched probably since the year 2000.
And what have you seen change over those years? You know, some years police seem to be really welcome and applauded, and other years you get a bit of a rough trot.
Look, I guess, you know, the type of role that we are in, it's all about diversity, inclusion and acceptance. We're also frontline police officers, and with that can obviously...
You get a bit of that.
You know, we can sometimes draw unfavourable attention for what we do, but all in all, you know, the police force is a diverse organisation, and you know, we'd like to represent that to the community out there that we are very accepting. And I think our acceptance over the years has really grown quite strong to the point where, you know, we're highly inclusive both internally and externally. And I think that shows with the number of glows we've now got.
How many people will be marching with you tonight?
Tonight we've got just over 40 marchers, and that's both sworn police and unsworn. A good number, great show. So
excellent show, and of course many, many more on the street.
Many, many more on the street tonight. Big police operation out there, and our key focus is obviously public safety, and we just like to wish everyone a happy, fun and great Mardi Gras. From all of us.
Well, Inspector Gemini Bakos, happy Mardi Gras to you too, and good luck tonight.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And happy Mardi Gras to you too.
Happy Mardi Gras indeed. You're listening to Joy 94.9, streaming on digital SBS Radio 3. We're broadcasting live from the Taylor Square. Shannon Power, Dean Beck. That was Superintendent Gemini Bakos. Now, the parade is moving a little bit slowly up the street. As far as I understand, the 78ers, the people who started it all, are slowly, slowly making their way up the street. And you can listen to us online.
We are broadcasting with live streaming online from the Mardi Gras website, mardigras.org.au, and SBS Online. sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. Now, Shannon Power, in Victoria, we were blessed to have a Commissioner of Sexuality and Gender, Rowena Allen. She's here today, and I caught up with her just before this very presentation. Well, with the drums, you can hear that the atmosphere is really building here at Mardi Gras 2016, and I've bumped into Victoria's own Sexuality and Gender Commissioner, Rowena Allen. Is this your first Mardi Gras, Ro?
First Mardi Gras as Commissioner, but yeah, not my first.
And you're marching with Beyond Blue. Georgie Harmon is here, CEO of Beyond Blue. Georgie, this is not your first year, I know that.
It's definitely not my first year. I've done a few of these. Second one for Beyond Blue.
What's your focus for this year?
Look, our focus, we're marching under the banner of love doesn't discriminate and neither should the law. So my board put out a statement in support of marriage equality towards the end of last year, and we're all marching under that banner tonight.
Now, Ro, yours is a government position. You have to take a neutral stance on everything. This is a fairly political statement by Beyond Blue.
Yeah, I'm marching with Beyond Blue. They're doing a great job in the LGBTI space. And also to highlight the fact that our community is overrepresented in depression, anxiety and mental health generally, and particularly young, vulnerable young people in our community. So hands off safer schools is my message tonight.
It's not going to get any better if we have that plebiscite, is it?
Absolutely not. We don't need it. We vote politicians in to make the decisions. We need to get on with it.
Well, Georgie Harmon, Rowena Allen, thank you both for joining us as we begin our 2016 Mardi Gras broadcast.
Happy Mardi Gras!
Thank you. Well, the question of the night is, do you believe in love? I know it can be difficult. Confusing, but we can never give up on love. And then,
Mardi Gras being cursed with rain, and everybody was really worried that was going to happen again because the forecast is that was the forecast rain, but it's clear. Let's go. What's up next, Dean Beck?
You are listening to the 2016 Mardi Gras Parade coming to you live from Taylor Square in Sydney. We're broadcasting and live streaming online from the Mardi Gras website, mardigras.org.au, and SBS online, sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. You can watch and listen live. We're on air on SBS Digital Radio 3, right around Australia on the Community Radio Network, and we are being brought to you by Joy 94.9. Now, Shannon, you have done a lot of work in the LGBTI space as a journalist.
Yes.
What does it mean for you as a straight woman to be here in this amazing celebration, this amazing event?
I've always felt, included in the community. As I say, I've grown up in the rainbow insulation, surrounded by the rainbow insulation. And what I like to see is the hard work that we do as journalists, but also as community members, to slowly, slowly make life more equitable for women and for LGBTI people. So I think that's fantastic. But, you know, we've got a whole team of people here that we're broadcasting with at the live Mardi Gras Parade broadcast. And we do.
Down on the parade route, in our box, we have Josh. Now, Josh, who have you got there with you?
So we are.
So Josh has got a whole heap of people. He's got Scott. He's got Dylan. Who else has he got?
Hello. Who's there?
Hey, guys. Josh. Dylan. And the crowd is going super, super wild down here. They're going absolutely crazy. Guys, what do we think is going to be happening?
A lot of glitter is what I'm expecting coming here tonight.
Now, you are absolutely covered, aren't you?
I tried to. I stole some of Dylan's glitter because I didn't bring anything with me. But I think we need some more glitter down here in the pit.
Oh, we definitely do. Now, I believe there is so much glitter down here. But I believe that there's a few people going to be buying a few more bits and pieces of glitter. So.
There's a lot of colour down here. You're wearing some magical wings.
Oh,
some nice little
wings.
Gold short shorts down here.
They are super, super short.
They are super short. Right, I'm looking at them right now.
Thanks.
I think we're all checking out good old Josh's short shorts. I have to say, the street team, we are looking pretty suave down here.
I definitely think so. We've done a good job.
I think so. I'm really keen for some of the folks, but I'm really curious, Grace, who are you really keen to see marching tonight?
I'm keen to see everybody, but particularly, I love a good drag queen, and I am very excited to see what they're going to be wearing tonight, marching down Oxford Street here.
Awesome stuff. Well, hey, we'll be down here chatting with a whole bunch of people, but what's going up on the main stage right now?
Well, thank you, Dylan. We are witnessing the first floats coming towards us. They are the ACON Aboriginal Project, the First Nation people, and this facilitates the first Australians, Aboriginal, Torres Strait Islander communities in the parade.
So the First Nations float has been around for a long time, and iconic Australian Aboriginal people have joined that float, but an interesting thing, if you don't have tickets to the official Mardi Gras after party, the Gadigal Information Centre and ACON are throwing a massive Club Puri after party full of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander drag queens, singers, and that'll be great to do after the Mardi Gras Parade if you are in Sydney.
And when they get to the very corner of Taylor Square and Flinders Street, here in front of us, they're
almost here.
They do like a little welcome to country.
They do a welcome to country, which is fantastic. We did ours at the start of the broadcast, but I think it's really important that the Gadigal people of New South Wales, of Sydney, just invite and welcome everyone to party on their land. And it's a very special moment every year in the Mardi Gras Parade. And they're just pulling around into the corner now. And they're slowing down. And I think we're just about to get ready to see the Welcome to Country. They've got a beautiful traditional English bus.
Now, that's it from you and I, Shannon Power. Coming up next, you'll be joined by...
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Your little girl is your princess, and her room is her castle.
Hi, I'm Rick from Happy Tint. Every princess needs privacy from eyes outside. Happy Tint adds a protective shield of privacy to your castle windows, without the need to draw curtains, close blinds, or heave up the drawbridge.
Happy Tint your princess to safety.
Happy Tint your home, your office, your car. Call 1-800-HAPPY-TINT.
Visit happytint.com.au.
Joy Swanson.
Houston, we have a problem. My wife has just left me for my sister.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
Looking for a gay CPA? Just above the Paran Market, Commercial Road Accounting can sort out all your tax and accounting needs. Call Joy sponsor Matt Anderson at Commercial Road Accounting, 9826 0999. 9826 0999.
G'day, I'm Clive Larkman, and it's Herb and Chili Festival time again.
Herb and Chili Festival!
9th and 20th of March, Warburton Highway, Wandon. We'll have stallholders from around the country with their latest chili and herb products, chili beer, local wines and much more for you to sample and buy. There'll be music and free activities for the kids, so bring the family along and enjoy the day. Jump on our website, herbchilifestival.com.au, to buy tickets, add a bit of spice to your life and come down to the Herb and Chili Festival, 9th and 20th of March, Warburton Highway, Wandon.
Joy sponsor.
The world's biggest 90s dance festival is coming to Australia for the first time in March. 90s Mania. Live in concert. Snap. Corona.
This is the rhythm of the night.
Culture Beat. CNC Music Factory. 90s Mania. Saturday, March 12, Track Lounge Bar. Ticketmaster.com.au. Relive the biggest hits of the 90s live. Tickets on sale now.
Joy sponsor.
Hi. I'm Hannah. Over 1 million children have been harmed by family violence. 1 in 5 women have suffered from domestic violence. And half of those women will be caring for children, like me.
At Berry Street, we know this is all of our problem. Violence is probably happening to someone in our own street. They're our kids. Please Google Hannah at Berry Street and donate today. It's urgent.
For kids like me.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Spectacular one, and in the theme of the night, it is rainbow.
Oh, bless. And just coming up behind the double-decker bus, I believe, able to be able to see on screen now, if you're watching on the live stream on SBS On Demand, you'll see the 78ers, the original people who protested back in 1978 and, you know, were horribly beaten by the police. And the reason this whole parade takes place.
Yeah, that's right. And this week is quite a significant one for the 78ers because they've now had apologies from the New South Wales Police Force, which is just so fantastic and historic and important.
Yes, it is. And, you know, the fact that we've managed to turn what was a protest rally now into a celebration of our cultural identity, I think, is an amazing testament to their very first steps towards equality.
Now, Adam, I know you were very good at school because you were telling me before. How old, on average, are the 78ers?
Oh, don't. That makes me doing maths.
Now, come on, they must be nearing 78, I think.
So they would have all been legally allowed to go to nightclubs in 1978.
It's such a fantastic night tonight. The weather is incredible. The spirit out here is truly fantastic.
It is. It is indeed. And we are meant to be getting the flag raised soon. I don't know whether that's happening or not.
Well, but I have seen the flag, and I'm telling you right now, Adam, it is huge. and it is coming. So I'm very much looking forward to that. It's the kind of flag that I love.
Oh, and right now, Paul Capsis is singing a song, bless him.
And what an outfit, dare I say. I've seen a lot of rainbow outfits tonight, but that is one that I want to borrow.
That is wonderful. Currently on screen, if you are watching on this, it's on demand or on the Mardi Gras website. The sisters of perpetual indulgence are enjoying the singing of Paul Capsis.
The night is truly taking off.
Oh, yeah. You know when Paul Capsis starts singing, everyone must drop to their knees immediately.
Oh dear, some injuries are about to happen at Mardi Gras tonight.
I don't think the 78ers have to drop to their knees.
No! Oh, Adam, thank gosh.
They're allowed to gently lower themselves down.
I think it must be happening soon, the raising of the flag. And if you are listening out on Joy right now, the flag is, you guessed it, very rainbow.
It is,
and
yes.
Very big.
It is a gigantic rainbow flag. It is...
It's about the size of a car, I'd say, or possibly even my bedroom.
Oh, no, bigger than a car. It's humongous.
We're looking forward
Speaking
to seeing
the rainbow. That is the song that Paul Capsis is singing. Is the what I like to call the Poofdaland national anthem. Somewhere over the rainbow, the Judy Garland classic from The Wizard of Oz. Because the rainbow flag does signify a lot for our community. You know, it is representative of the various stripes and colours of our community. Many very varied and different people come together to create this gigantic melting pot that we have.
Absolutely. It basically represents all the different colours of the rainbow. In other words, all the different people that come together to make up the LGBTQIA+ community. Yeah, I know, right? I've gotten very good. I was practicing for tonight, Adam. No, but in all seriousness, it's a fantastic flag and it's a fun flag.
It is, although it is impossible to dress for it. Like, what do you wear?
You were saying earlier it does not match your complexion, and you're a handsome man, so I'm surprised.
But I constantly clash with the rainbow flag. You're always clashing with some part of it, aren't you?
We can also see Auslan. The Auslan choirs are joining in.
So they are signing for Paul Capsis as he reaches the crescendo.
Yes. For the hearing impaired members of our community, and of course the hearing impaired members in Australia at large, there's plenty to see.
We have some absolutely spectacular fireworks going off right now.
I had no idea flames could be coloured.
They are coloured pyrotechnic. It is absolutely wonderful, and just the crowd has gone incredibly wild. On the roof of Kinsella, just behind us, fireworks shooting into the sky.
Look at that. The crowd is lighting up here in Sydney tonight at the Mardi Gras with thanks to some beautiful fireworks that I must say are coming out of the pub that old mate Malcolm Turnbull was in before.
We did wave hello to the Prime Minister just an hour ago.
And he did wave back, and there it is. The flag
has been raised.
It's high and it is proud.
It is quite humongous. It's about the size of a bus.
Honestly, it's the size of a very expensive Sydney apartment, if you ask me.
Nothing's that small.
Oh, this is so much fun.
This is wonderful. The fireworks, though, I should point out, Greta, that fireworks are not a huge surprise in Sydney. They seem to go off about every 6 seconds.
This is so true, isn't it? Okay, we are going to Scott. He is out in the street.
Yes. Hello, Scott. What's going on down there?
Hi, I've got Harry here, who's one of the 78ers. Harry, it's been a big week. You've had a couple apologies. Mm-hmm. Tell us, how does tonight feel to you?
Well, this is a celebration for us now, because it was quite emotional in Parliament House with the sorry from the politicians. So now we can let our hair down, if you've still got here.
Thanks so much, Harry. Happy Mardi Gras.
My first 78, I was old then.
Back to you.
Thank you, Scott. Oh, and thank you, Harry. What a wonderful, wonderful thing. Hearing from one of the original 78ers.
I know, and I don't want to say it's a slice of history, because, hey, Harry's still with us, and he's going strong and proud. But it really is such a momentous week for the 78ers.
It is.
And it must be an extra special parade for them.
Oh, it would be. Also, you know, they lost many of their the original 78ers through the terrible AIDS crisis in the intervening years. So this is a very bittersweet day for them as well. So there's, you know, a number of people who did not make it to hear that apology. But what a wonderful world we live in now, where they are able to have the government, have the police say sorry for what happened all those years ago.
That's right.
It's so amazing.
And just, I can't even imagine the feeling of being one of the people who first started tonight.
Yes. Like, you wouldn't have imagined it. Like, it was just a lot of very angry people.
Yeah, well, yeah, and rightly so.
Very angry people, and now it has turned into what is a global phenomenon. Every year, people come from all around the world to participate and to watch this parade. I feel like most of them are right in front of us now.
Yeah. Taking a look, we are seeing the crowd right now.
There are so many
happy faces, so many people waving. And it's just great to see everyone from Sydney, it feels like, here with us. And it's not just the gay, lesbian, LGBTQI community. It's our pink flag friends as well.
Yes.
It's our straight friends in the community out here to show support for their friends and family, colleagues.
Yes.
So it's picked up beautifully over there in the sky.
Very high. This is Adam Richard and Greta Larkins with you on Joy 94.9. Also broadcasting on SBS Digital and SBS On Demand. And you can hear us through the Community Radio Network.
That's right. Head to sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras to take a look at what we can see right now.
The footage is spectacular. There are cameras everywhere, so you're going to get a spectacular view of the parade if you get on to your website right now. But yeah, it is looking spectacular. All of the audience is looking amazing, like the people crowding around the streets having a ball.
There are so many incredible costumes, and no doubt we'll only see more and more of those as the night unfolds. And not just rainbows. I'm obsessing over rainbows.
You are obsessing over the rainbow.
I've seen Greek gods. I've seen all sorts of gear out there on the members of the community, loud, proud, having such fun.
I was enjoying the view across the road from us. There's someone having what looks like a private party upstairs, and they have two waiters wearing nothing but aprons.
Now, here's an outfit that's a little bit more elaborate than aprons. Adam, you've got your glasses on. Tell me, what can you see over there?
It looks like a boat with a woman on the front of it.
It's true. It is a boat with a built-in human.
Mardi Gras float.
Ah, fantastic.
And the figurehead on the front of the boat is an actual woman.
Oh, I love it. The figurehead on the front of the boat. That's right. It's not a, I guess they're wooden traditionally, aren't they? Now we're testing my boating knowledge. No, that is a living, breathing human being.
Yes, a living figurehead.
Oh, how exciting.
And there go the colourful fireworks again. This is absolutely breathtaking.
And following our boat are some gorgeous sequined gowns in ocean blue, Adam. I did do theatre studies at school. I understand conceptual concepts.
I believe the semiotics of that is that they are meant to be the ocean that the boat is sailing on. And also you can see some of them are holding oars as if they're rowing the boat. So
they're rowing the gay community forward, I think.
Or perhaps they're meant to be representative of ancient Greece.
Oh, I love it. They're oceanic pioneers.
Yes. But yes, it's a spectacular outfit, like an entire boat as a dress.
I don't want to know how they're attached to the boat. That makes me nervous. I'm not very good at those sort of things. All right, here we go. Now, if that's not a mohawk, I don't know what is. Adam, honestly, and I'm a big RuPaul's Drag Race fan, but now that's a costume.
That is a spectacular costume. I would imagine that is Ron Muncaster, who has won the costume award for, I think, 6 or 7 times, and he's been a finalist for 11 or 12 times. He's, you know, quite a spectacular, regular addition to the parade. Amazing costume designer. So
And you're kidding, and really, rightly so.
Looks like he's outdone himself this year.
I know, now all I want to do is get in his wardrobe. Hold on, that doesn't sound right. But you know what I mean, what an incredible costume.
It does look like the headpiece looks like a gigantic admiral's hat.
Oh, I love it. Oh! Oh, look at him go. What a fantastic outfit.
It is spectacular. Gigantic feathers in the hat and so many sequins.
I mean, if there's one thing you're going to get at Mardi Gras, it is sequins. But that right there is how to do sequins 101. Yes. That is the benchmark of sequins. He has said the sequin precinct.
He has indeed. And now we have Teresa Campara, or Mrs. Christmas, as she's known.
I know, that's the rumour, isn't it?
Yeah, she's a local identity in Sydney.
Oh, and, fantastic.
You know, gets to walk at the front of the parade every year. And, God, she looks incredible, doesn't she?
Yeah, I just love what she's wearing. That is such a fantastic skirt. And it's just so great to see, I guess, the faces around Sydney as a local, as a member of the community. No matter what, who you are, you just get to know.
Teresa dresses like that more often than not.
Well, if her nickname truly is Mrs. Christmas, I need to get to her house for Christmas lunch. Adam, that's our goal.
I think every lunch would be Christmas lunch with Mrs. Christmas. I'll just go there on a Thursday and be Christmas lunch.
Oh, dig in. I do love a roast. Oh, it's really starting to unfold now.
It is indeed. And now we have the Sydney Queer Irish Pirate Queen.
Now, this will tickle my mum's fancy because we have Irish heritage.
Oh, excellent.
And it's good to see some beautiful Irish green.
Yes, we love a bit of green. Now we've got a bit of blue. We have another boat.
I'm sensing a theme.
I am sensing a theme. Is it an aquatic theme this year, obviously?
And that is Panty Bliss on the boat. No, I'm not swearing, but I hope my nieces aren't listening. That's right, Panty Bliss at the front of the ship.
Look, I'm loving them. I'm loving all the ships. And I'm having difficulty saying ships because it can come across as the wrong word on the radio if you're not careful.
Come now, Adam, no swearing. You promised me earlier.
Panty Bliss, bless her. What an amazing, amazing one.
And Panty Bliss appears to have a true... Look, I'm going to cut to the chase. Very good-looking men with pleated capes.
Lots of men who've been working very hard all year on their abs and not very long on this dance routine. But bless them, they're giving it a red-hot go. And I love them for it.
Oh, Adam, you've got to be in it to win it. And gym membership has peaked in the last month in inner-city Sydney in readiness for tonight's, display.
Don't I know it? I was here in Sydney a few days ago eating at a local Chinese restaurant, and on the other side I could see into the window of a gym and there were about 30 people staring at me.
Well, we have one of the members of the Sydney Queer Irish down with our street team. Should we come to them?
Oh, we should indeed. Hello.
Hey, I'm still in here with Pat from Sydney Queer Irish. Hey, Pat, what's going on tonight?
Oh, it's absolutely fabulous tonight, isn't it? Don't they look amazing?
Oh, I have to say, you look stunning. I'm loving the fishnet and the sequins. You look totally just like gothic glitterati. I love it.
We are the Viking pirates, so let's not be confused by this.
Is that glitter or war paint?
Both.
Both. Excellent. Well, Pat, thank you so much for chatting with me. Happy Mardi Gras. Mwah. Thanks, guys. Back to you on the decks.
Thank you, Dylan.
Great stuff.
Thanks, Dylan.
And it's true. There's a lot of gold out there at the moment.
There is a lot of gold right now. We are surrounded by gold.
And it's true. Glitterati, I think, is really cutting to the chase. I've been offered glitter a few times tonight, and I am not talking about anything dodgy. Adam, don't give me that look. I'm talking about glitter in its purest form.
I'm giving you that look because I am terrified of going home with any glitter on me.
Me too.
Oh, my God, we're glitter phobes.
We're glitter phobes. Oh, gosh, we're going to get kicked out of Mardi Gras any second now.
This is the worst place we could possibly be, in the middle of Taylor Square for Mardi Gras. We are broadcasting to you on Joy 94.9 and the Community Radio Network. You can also hear this broadcast on SBS On Demand and SBS Digital Radio 3. And you can catch the footage on SBS On Demand and the Mardi Gras website. So, plenty of places to see and hear Mardi Gras. But I hope if you... not here in Sydney, you're having a wonderful night wherever you are. It is absolutely spectacular here. I hear police sirens. I hope that they're for the parade and not for something terrible.
I have an inkling that they will be. Oh, yep, I could see those lights flashing. They're coming soon.
We do have the transgender rights group currently marching on screen. You'll be able to see them. And obviously all those sirens from the police.
That's right. We are joined by the Australian Federal Police right now.
Yes, the Gay and Lesbian Liaison Officer Network.
And they're here. They're here, like so many of the groups tonight, to increase a positive image of the community.
Yes. We're going to cross now, I think, down to Megan, who is marching with the Transgender Rights Group. Hello, Megan.
Hey, Megan. That's Josh. We've got Megan right here. How are you, Megan?
Hey, guys. How are you? We're actually having a fantastic time tonight here at Mardi Gras. It's amazing. Everyone's turned out. Sydney's really turned on the weather, and the place is absolutely pumping with an electric atmosphere. This is an amazing place to be.
Megan, tell us, what does Mardi Gras mean to you?
You know, I think for lots of people here, Mardi Gras means a celebration of our own unique individuality, and we exist within a group and within a collective. And what's really important is an event like this is to see the unity that we all have.
Well, thank you so much, Megan. Have a wonderful time. We won't keep you any longer. Back to you guys.
Thanks so much. Thank you, Megan. So as you can see now, the Australian Federal Police, and the message that they want to get across by marching today is that they want to increase the positive image of law enforcement and the work undertaken.
And so many of Australia's police officers, not just the Australian Federal Police, but all over, are members of the LGBTQI plus community.
That is true. And it is amazing that we are now here in 2015, so far away from the situation that we had with police back in 1978, which is what started this parade. And it's a wonderful, wonderful thing.
And it's such a sign of unity and a sign of peace. And it's just great to have, I guess, so many different groups in the community involved in the parade tonight.
It is absolutely wonderful. This is Adam Richard and Greta Larkin with you on Joy 94.9 for the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. We are broadcasting live from Taylor Square, and we're shouting because it's very loud.
Yeah. It's very loud, and it's very proud, and it's very good fun.
It is very good fun. Now we can see, I believe, the New South Wales Ambulance Service going past.
Yeah, that's right. And as an organisation, they are delivering vital life-saving service to the community every day, absolutely. They're here to stress that there's no division, no boundaries, and together we are one. I love it.
Bless them all. We also have the New South Wales State Emergency Service. Their float is called Orange Pride.
Oh, I love it.
Plus they wear an orange uniform. With the
SES. Isn't that great? And of course the SES, can you imagine? What an intense job, and they're all volunteers.
Yes.
So a big round of applause for the SES tonight in fantastic orange pants in their gear.
Oh, I know.
Adam, I could see bagpipes, your favourite instrument.
It is my favourite instrument. We've just had the defence and go past. And we've also got the Rural Fire Service, but here the Defence Force is going past now with their marching band and looking absolutely spectacular.
Fantastic. I do love a marching band. I should run down there and get amongst it. I fancy myself a bit of a drum player, to be honest with you.
And we do have all branches of the Defence Forces marching tonight. We've got the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, everyone.
We're in safe hands.
I know. We're in very safe hands. Someone wanted to mount an insurgency.
There's some fantastic uniform marching, which I must say tickles my fancy.
Oh, and look, you know, we have one of the most progressive Defence Forces in the world. We have a group captain who is transgender, and it is like in an effort, and it's just an amazing thing that we can have that in this day and age. That, you know, it's just a wonderful, wonderful thing that our defence forces are so, so embracing of every type of community.
Because every member of the community should have the opportunity, if they choose, to defend Australia or to be part of
the army and the other sort of forces that we have. So it's so great that now, collectively, everyone can be embraced.
Yes, the Australian Air Force does have the highest ranking transgender member of the military in the world.
Wow, that's fantastic.
We are the most progressive. We win.
Adam, we have leveraged so much positivity tonight.
Listen to us, go.
So I know, right? No, he is kidding. Adam is lovely. He's pulling our collective leg right there.
Not just your leg.
Hey, that's for later.
You brought it. Well, let's not go there. This is the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras, and Richard and Greta Larkin with you from Joy 94.9. We are broadcasting across SBS Digital, SBS On Demand, and the Mardi Gras website, as well as the Community Radio Network.
So thank you
for joining us. We have someone from the Rural Fire Service who are marching down now.
I got right here. We've grabbed you off the street.
Kel.
So tell us about how many times have you been marching?
This is my fourth year marching.
How many?
Four.
Four?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. So what does it mean to you tonight?
We get out with the service and help everyone. Someone's got to do it. So we just come out and have fun.
Oh, that's awesome. And listen to all that noise. Beautiful orange.
Absolutely.
You have a great Mardi Gras.
Yeah, you too. Happy Mardi Gras, guys.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you to the Rural Fire Service who look after all of country New South Wales, mostly a volunteer force. So that's, you know, amazing for them to come to town and walk in the parade and show their support. Fantastic. So amazing. So we've got the New South Wales Rural Fire Service. Obviously, there are many, many sirens going on. Corrective Services New South Wales is after justice.
Now, in 1996, only two CS New South Wales employees marched in the Mardi Gras parade with the words, "We're here too."
Oh, wow.
And I'm not great at counting, so I'm not going to give it a red hot go.
No.
But there's an awful lot more of them out there tonight, Adam.
Quite a number.
How fantastic.
But yeah, it's great to see so many of the emergency services, Metropolitan and tonight. It's such an amazing feeling of support as well, whether it be that they have, you know, members of our community in their ranks or they just want to show their support.
Yeah, that's right. And you don't need to be gay or lesbian to take part in this parade. You don't need to be trans or identify as queer. You can be a good old-fashioned straight person who wants to show support. I think they're the best of the bunch, but I'm not meant to pick favourites. But it's just so great to see everyone out there, no matter who you are, because really I think we all fit on the rainbow, and that's the best thing about the rainbow flag.
It represents everybody.
We should dedicate the straight people a colour by the end of tonight, Adam. Let's take another listen. We're heading down to our street team now with another member of the Rural Fire Brigade.
Hey, how's it going?
I'm standing here with Chrissy. Now, Chrissy, tell me what brought it into you to join our Rural Fire Service.
Sorry, I'm with Fire and Rescue. I didn't hear your question, sorry.
Oh, that's okay. I was asking, why is it important for you to be marching with Fire and Rescue right now?
Because I support gay and lesbian rights, and I want equal marriage, and I run a musical theatre company, and my life is full of gay and lesbian, and it's their turn.
Oh, we absolutely love what you're doing. Happy Mardi Gras.
Yeah, thank you very much. And Fire and Rescue, we also support gay and lesbian firefighters as well, so...
Excellent stuff. We love you. Happy Mardi Gras. Wow, it's a buzz down here. What's it like back upstairs?
Oh, it's amazing. Thank you so much. Happy Mardi Gras. We are about to wrap up and leave you.
We will be back, though.
We will be back later on. We're going to leave you in the capable hands of Matt McDonald and Emily Dwyer. Greta, thank you so much for joining me for this half hour.
This has been a blast. And Adam, I've got to say, New South Wales legal aid has just appeared.
Oh, excellent.
And
pleasure.
These people are close to my heart because they help out people with legal issues. And I work part-time for a lawyer. And so if you have a legal issue and you don't have the cash, these are our people.
They will look after you. Also, transport for New South Wales going past. We will be back with you after 8:30. As I said, with Matt McDonald and Emily Swine, Adam Richard and Greta Larkins.
is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
From the outrageously adorned to the sassy, satirical and serious, SBS is showcasing the truly incredible 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Hosted by Patrick Abood, Faustina Agoli, Tom Ballard and Magda Szybanski. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Tomorrow 8:30 on SBS. Reflecting diversity.
Joy sponsor.
Whether you're packing up your home or relocating your office, Alexander Removals and Storage make light work of any job, around Melbourne or interstate. The personalised service you get from Alexander's is second to none, and all work is carried out with total care and attention. So before you move anywhere, call Joy sponsor Alexander's Removals and Storage on 95791864 or see their ad under Furniture Removals and Storage in the Yellow Pages. Alexander's Removals and Storage, around Melbourne or interstate.
Chapel Street is bringing the party to the back streets as part of Melbourne Food and Wine Festival. Grab your friends and join us for a Sunday session in celebration of Melbourne's best urban street food with party vibe tunes, street art, circus arts and hip hops and drops. This free event, proudly supported by Deliveroo, takes place on Sunday, March 6th from 1 till 9pm in the Artist's Lane between Green and Union Streets. Then kick on after the party from 8 till late at Hoo Ha. For full lineup, visit chapelstreet.com.au. The Windsor & Co. Block Party, presented by the Chapel Street Precinct, a Joy sponsor.
I spy with my Vista Eye something beginning with D. Doctor. Not only is Dr. Rick Wolfe at Vista Eyes one of Australia's most experienced eye surgeons, he's also internationally recognised, having spoken at numerous conferences all over the world. Dr. Wolfe has performed over 17,000 eye surgeries, including on his own friends, family and Vista Eyes staff. So you can see, you're in safe hands. I spy with my Vista Eye. Your free appointment. Phone 1800 50 50 49.
Joy sponsor.
No matter who takes you home on your weekdays, you won't be left disappointed.
I love being taken home by Jax and Greta.
I never miss Chris and Cap.
You gotta love David and Sue.
Lulu and Michael, what a scream.
Oh, Dano and Mason. Now that's a new way to be taken home.
Let Joy take you home. 4 to 7 on weekdays. With thanks to Diversity Expo, the largest LGBTI exhibition heading to Melbourne's Convention and Exhibition Centre April 16 and 17. Diversityexpos.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Joy 94.9 in Melbourne or any community radio station in centres big and small around the country. Now joining me for the next half hour, Matt.
Hi Emily, it's all happening here.
How excited are you?
Oh, this is fantastic. We've got Egyptian style float coming past us right now with all the buff boys and all their glitter. There's no shortage of glitter here in Sydney.
There's no glitter anywhere else in Australia. All the glitter's been shipped to Sydney for this weekend. It's very, very exciting.
A glut of glitter. The crowd is absolutely roaring and giving all these people, they've got their whole dance moves going, the glowing sticks, flashing them around in the air. They're coming together now for a bit of a powwow right in the middle of Taylor Square in the heart of Sydney and the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
Coming up, rainbow babies and kids just walking over the rainbow crossing. Now, you can take a look at the video, but if you're not in that position, Bruno is amazing.
I do really love, Emily, the rainbow babies and kids, showing that family is family no matter what. So having the kids along with their two dads, their two mums, their mixed families, whatever, their opportunity to be a part of Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. I really love that.
Really love that. Now, the technicians have been fiddling with my mouth, and apparently everything is okay now. So there's a lovely rainbow crossing draped all the way across Taylor Square. A giant, giant flag and a beautiful, beautiful breeze. The rainbow flag is rippling, and there's what looks like a queer helicopter. A queer copter.
A queer copter.
Now we're crossing over to our street team with someone from the ANZ Bank.
Our crew down there is doing a great job trying to get us interviews right on the ground, but the parade is moving quite fast. It's got momentum, Emily, I would say, and that is, in fact, the theme of this year's Sydney Queer Mardi Gras.
And isn't it such an important theme for us right now? They've got attacks on our community coming from a range of right-wing and conservative and some Christian sources. It really is a time where, you know, it's wonderful to party and we're having so much fun here, but we need to think about the politics too. We need to push through marriage equality and then onto all the other kinds of issues that our community needs to address culturally, politically, legally. There's a lot to do, everyone.
And one way that those issues can be raised is on film. Coming past us now is the Gaby Baby Team, which is that very controversial documentary that was banned in New South Wales schools. Well, they're getting a showing tonight here at the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras, and everybody's giving them a big, big cheer.
In those kind of political issues we were just talking about. In fact, there was a big community meeting coming up in Sydney on Monday night. There was one of these meetings in Melbourne on Thursday last week. 300 people got together to talk about what we can all do to push back against the attacks. At the New South Wales Teachers Federation Union in Surry Hills, Monday, 6:30 p.m. Get on Facebook, LGBTIQA Community Response Sydney, and you can be part of our community's response to... And we've got someone from the Rainbow Babies we're ready to talk to. Street team.
Cindy from Rainbow Babies and Kids. Cindy, how are you tonight?
Very well, very well. We're enjoying the Mardi Gras very much.
And who do we have here?
Matthias.
Matthias, how are you?
Good.
Good, are you enjoying yourself?
Yes.
Fantastic, I won't hold you any longer. Happy Mardi Gras. See you guys, back to you.
Oh, look, what a buzz. What a buzz that would be for those kids. The kids are getting a huge, huge cheer from the crowd, and so they should. Great support here from the crowd for the Rainbow Babies. And Rainbow Families coming up, they're all in white. They're showing the very different sides of Rainbow Families. Together we sparkle is their theme, and they are indeed sparkling with glittery silver and white.
Yeah. Representatives from transparents. But I saw some of these, I caught the train here today and saw some people wearing some lovely t-shirts. Families are about love. Love makes a family.
It does. We all have a family. We shouldn't forget that. It's not about gay or straight. Everybody has a family. And the love is certainly being shown to them here tonight.
And we actually have had a question that's come in about why this is called the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras, as opposed to, say, the Sydney Queer Mardi Gras or the Sydney LGBTIQ Mardi Gras. And we'll answer that question coming up very shortly. We're going to head over to the street team to talk to someone from a trans family.
Josh, how are you?
I'm doing fabulous, thank you. How are you?
Good, thank you. Is this your first year marching?
This is our second. I'm here with my family. We're having an amazing time.
Yeah, you guys look fabulous.
Thank you, thank you.
Well, what does Mardi Gras mean to you guys?
As a gay person with a gay brother, it means that with my family, we can march together and be proud of who we are.
Exactly, and there's so many of you out tonight. It's just amazing to see you guys. Have a lovely Mardi Gras.
You too, happy Mardi Gras.
Happy Mardi Gras, guys. Back to you guys.
Thanks, team, and coming up right behind them is P Flag. Now, P Flag, every year, gets just the biggest cheer. It's the parents and friends of lesbians and gays. They are getting such a great response. There's signs there, I love my trans child, transgender rights are human rights, respect. All these themes coming out around parents and friends of lesbians and gays. They've got these groups all around Australia, regional and city areas. So this is a very important group. And another thing that this group does, Emily, is that they have been very big advocating to the government for change on things, on basic rights and particularly marriage rights. So that's P Flag racing up the street, getting enormous, enormous cheers. Always pretty much the biggest cheer every year. We've got a big caterpillar it looks like coming up now. This is the inner city legal service. They've been providing legal support to the likes of the LGBT community for the past 35 years.
And this year their message is the inner city legal centre supports change for transgender people. There's no consistent approach across the states and territories and the Commonwealth to changing your gender identity documents. And also, court involvement is mandatory before trans children can begin hormones. So the ICLC supports and represents these teenagers and their parents navigating what is a really, really, really complex legal system. Good on you, ICLC.
Yeah, they're right there on our side. We love having them with us. Coming up, I just mentioned that we have people all around Australia. Well, here's the group from Canberra.
It's wonderful to see families marching together, older people, younger people, to see the diversity of families in the crowd as well. It's been wonderful to see, I think, over the last 12 months or so, just the visibility of trans families in the media as well. Families supporting their young trans kids. A shout out to all the trans kids who might be listening to our broadcast tonight. You're part of Sydney's Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
And speaking of kids, we've got the youth blokes coming up now. It's 2010, the Gay and Lesbian Youth Project here in Sydney. Along with the Gay and Lesbian Counselling Service, the second oldest counselling service in Australia. Only Lifeline's been running longer, the GLCS, doing some fantastic work. Got lots of young people, adolescents, showing their pride and waving flags.
Creating spaces to be you is their theme. Lots of sparkling people just having a great time being young, being queer, being out. An amazing change there's been over 10, 20, 30 years.
Indeed.
The kinds of experiences that the older generations had.
How much it has changed. The other thing that's changed is social media, and we have Facebook are on board of the market. You can actually show you care and change your Facebook profile with the I Heart Marriage Equality on Facebook.
These in some ways are more difficult than others. Kids living their lives in public on Facebook and social media. Reachout.com is just coming past us now. The leading online mental health service providing information and support to young Australians to help them and their mates through tough times. And they're also picking up on the Mardi Gras theme of momentum to deliver a bread float that's all about building better futures for our young people in this community.
We also have Q Live there, which is the National LGBTI Phone Counselling Service, which helps people reach or get like nationally on the phone number 1-800-1-8-LCS. Q Live.
New South Wales Teachers Federation. Teaching makes all the difference. Law schools are taking on LGBTI inclusive education practices. This is such an important group given the attacks on the safe schools coalition that we've seen in Australia over the last couple of weeks. Amazing to see the Teachers Federation marching. Amazing to see all the young people marching. And as I said, if you are interested in being part of the response to the attacks and you are living in Sydney, get on down to the union on Monday night to be part of that community response. And we have someone from the Teachers Union with the street team now. Go!
Wow, they've pumped up the music here. And we've got people dancing in their props.
Now, you're from the New South Wales Teachers Federation.
One, yep.
What's it like at the moment being a teacher, given what's happening in the media?
Oh, look, teachers are doing hard work to try and educate people. Diverse schools, safe schools, so important. And we're pretty much devastated about the safe school stuff, but we keep educating, keep getting diverse communities, safe students, safe schools, beautiful places.
Thank you so much for the work that you do. We need more teachers like you.
That's all right. Happy Mardi Gras.
Happy Mardi Gras. Back to you guys.
Thanks so much, Scott. A as we were talking to the Teachers Federation, the Rural and Regional Alliance of Queer Students has come past us. They're in rainbow academic gowns. What if all those things they were on their heads?
Of course. It's like they've all graduated in their gay colours.
Yay! It's a message to the people in the crowd or watching at home that we are in the country and we don't need to leave to be happy. That there are communities to be found even in the country. So thank you very much for coming to Sydney, being part of the Mardi Gras with us. And if you're listening to this broadcast somewhere outside of a city area, you're amazing. We love you.
Emily, it's fantastic to see so many rural and regional groups who are part of this. It's not just Sydney, it is for the whole of Australia.
People have come to be part of the Mardi Gras parade from all over the country. And people in the crowd, people have come from all over the world. We're talking a bit earlier to someone who's come from Chicago. There are people from all continents of the world that we've been bumping into. This is not just a Sydney event, it's not just an Australia event, this is a global event.
Indeed, and lots of people watching on sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras, taking the live feed of tonight's broadcast. We've got Pride Unlimited in front of us right now, taking their things. And we're just visiting Facebook, Share the Love, so they're involved, their partners in Mardi Gras coming across in front of us now. You can change your profile pic to support marriage equality here in Australia.
I think we love it when we get that kind of corporate support, but we love it when people actually put their money where their mouth is and actually support the community. I think
the community
is not a marketing segment. You know, we're not people that you can sell things to or think for yourself with. We'd love your support, but I guess with that comes we're not a responsibility to help out. So for those of you who are helping out, thank you very much.
We should also remember that all of these businesses have LGBTI staff and they form a part of the place that comes to you tonight and they're sharing the love of Mardi Gras.
Now, Matt, you were once in the parade, I believe.
I actually did the pre-parade entertainment called Foreplay. So when they cut the roads at 5 o'clock in the evening, basically a whole group of entertainers come up and down and keep people busy until 7:30 when the real action starts. So, yes, I've done that for a few years. Absolute ball.
And did you have a name?
I actually did it in drag. My name was Delilah Number. Doing some work for the Gay Lesbian Counselling Service. Yes, it was funny because we could walk up to people that we knew and they had no idea that we were. We've got some horny devils coming up here now. It's the Immigration Advice and Rights Centre, a community legal centre providing free legal advice to people seeking asylum. What a hot, hot issue that is here in Australia right now, especially for LGBTI asylum seekers.
Absolutely. If there's injustice anywhere, there's injustice everywhere.
Absolutely.
After everyone. I think someone said that before. And now we have someone from the Immigration and Rights Centre. They're talking to Josh.
Sophie, is this your first time marching tonight?
It's not. It's my second time.
Your second? And what are you enjoying most about tonight?
The crowd, the atmosphere, the free, loving, embracing spirit.
That's all right, Sophie. Thank you so much and happy Mardi Gras.
Thank you. Guys, happy Mardi Gras.
Back to you guys.
It is indeed a happy Mardi Gras. Everybody here is happy. We're up here in the Lockheed Heights in the stands. It is packed with people and everybody is well and truly happy.
A bit of retro dancing, a few retro skirts.
A little retro car as well, looks like it's out of the 60s.
This is retro quality. Started. Oh! Well, we'll talk more about retro quality. We've got someone from My Little Peony with the street team.
Hey, it's Dylan here and I'm with...
Robin.
Robin.
How are you going, Dylan?
I'm going really well tonight. I'm loving what everyone's wearing, but tell me, who are you marching with tonight?
We're marching with Celebrate Under Celebrate Love with My Little Peony. We want to get married, and the only way to do that is to show how much love there is in the world.
And are you marching with one? Are you marching with your partner tonight?
Yes, I am. She's just right over there.
She is right there. You two look stunning. I hope you have a fabulous Mardi Gras.
Thank you. You too.
Robin, say excellent. Hey, both going back upstairs.
Thanks, Dylan. My Little Peony, Retro Equality, and Amnesty International, the LGBTIQ network, has just gone past. What are they up to, Matt?
Look, we actually, they're quite regular with us on Worldwide Wave, one of Joy's international programs in Melbourne. And in fact, we're going to speak to them right now with the street team. Take it away, guys.
Hey, well, I'm standing here with someone from Amnesty and the Human Rights. So what was your name?
My name's Lizzie and I'm from Amnesty International.
And Lizzie, now talk me through what's been your favourite part about the Mardi Gras so far?
The season or the parade?
Oh, which one do you rather?
Well, I'm glad the wind died down because we have an awfully big banner. So people can read that human rights are our pride on our banner now.
Excellent stuff. Well, do you know, it is absolutely smashing talking with you. How much glitter is on you right now?
Sorry?
How much glitter is on you right now?
Quite a lot. quite a bit.
Lizzie, you look sensational. Thank you so much for having a chat with me.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dylan. Amnesty International urging all of us to join and add momentum to the fight for human rights. Now, whatever glitter wasn't on her, looks like it's strewn all over the street. There's somebody who... let's crush over to the Equality Group with our street team.
Hi, Talia. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Thank you. How's your Mardi Gras going?
So fun. It's my first one, so I'm really excited.
You guys look so fabulous. And what does Mardi Gras mean to you guys?
Equality.
And this is going to be our year. It's going to be legal this year.
Oh, definitely.
I hope so. I think it's time, guys. Have a great Mardi Gras.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you, guys.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, Tony Abbott is part of the Mardi Gras parade. Is that what I'm seeing?
Well, I don't know if it's him in person.
Hi, Tony!
Is that right? We've got marriage celebrants here as well, supporting the parade. They're supporting a change to the marriage equality law. We've got a circular dance going on here at the moment with umbrellas, rainbow-coloured umbrellas. This is all a part of a community entrance. And they've got a glitter cannon that's just showering everybody with glitter.
It wasn't Tony Abbott. It was someone dressed as Tony Abbott, I'm sure. But thanks, Tony, for no support.
And look, we've got a slight break in the parade. A shout out to all the volunteers that are a part of... Oh, here come the fireworks. The volunteers who mind the parade, they help put this whole event together. Good on you, Mardi Gras volunteers.
There's fireworks in the background. There's colourful flames.
There's
in the foreground.
Flames. I've never seen that before. They're actually different coloured flames. All the colours of the rainbow. I love that. I want one.
It's going to be dangerous in your lap. Let's head over to the street team.
Hi, this is Scott on the street, and I'm talking with...
Sue!
Sue, who are you marching with tonight?
We're marching with the Social Justice and Early Childhood Group.
And tell us about what's... You're all dressed absolutely beautifully. How many times have you done this?
This is our second time, but we've brought along some family members and some children this time, so it's really special for us.
Now, the theme this year is momentum. What does that mean to you?
That means that we've made some progress in making early childhood inclusive and diverse, but there's a long way to go.
Thank you, Sue. Happy Mardi Gras.
Happy Mardi Gras.
Back to you guys.
We've got pride and diversity with us now. Now, this is a group that works within the workplaces to bring change. So actually have a system where you can almost be accredited as an LGBTI-friendly organisation. And that's a massive turnout here.
Not quite work attire. So a lot of cut-off shirts, a lot of bow ties, a lot of sparkles, a lot of lights, and lots of little tiny, 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 tiny black shorts, which look very, very beautiful. But
I think I think Sydney must be sold out of tiny, tiny, tiny shorts. All the XXS, S, extra small, they're all gone. Probably some large sizes there. This next boat looks like a Vegemite contingent almost. They've got the old black and gold going on. And we're crossing down to the street team now. We've got another street side interview.
Hey, Matt, I'm still in here and I'm sitting here with Ross from Pride and Diversity. What's going on?
Pride and Diversity have a float, the largest ever float of its kind, float this year. Essentially, we have 200 dancers. We have a record number of CEOs and senior executives from our organisations that we support marching with us.
Excellent stuff. And he's wearing a sequins blazer and these amazing hot pants. Terry, was it your idea to wear this tonight?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. I had a little bit of extra weight that I wanted to hide this time.
Oh, well, you look like a total stud. I hope to see you at the after party, Ross.
I wish.
Back to you guys up there. What's going on, Matt?
That is actually where the parade is heading towards, that after party. But in the meantime, we've got the Kirsten Road Centre, which is the HIV support service here in Sydney. And they've been a part of the parade for 25 years, which is a fantastic effort, committed to helping to end HIV.
We're in that part of the parade. Positive Life New South Wales. HIV positive or HIV negative. Positive Life New South Wales helps all of us play our part in HIV prevention. Lots of people in lab coats.
And the Fermi Institute, which is a major research body in HIV, coming up as well, showing their pride 30 years of research in HIV field. You are on Joy's live broadcast from Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. We're 94.9 and sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. You can watch the live feed.
You can also listen and watch on SBS, or listen on SBS Radio 3.
SBS Radio, and actually a lot of community radio stations as well, picking us up.
And let's cross down to someone from the Kirby Institute with our screen team.
It's Josh, and who do we have here?
Courtney from the Kirby Institute.
Courtney, is this your first time marching tonight?
No, it's my second with the Kirby.
Second? And are you having fun?
Of course, it's Mardi Gras. You've got to have fun.
Seen any interesting things?
Plenty of interesting things. Mardi Gras is always a stellar performance and amazing costumes and amazing performance.
And what are you doing later tonight?
Party, party, party.
Fantastic, Courtney. Well, thank you so much and happy Mardi Gras. Guys, we'll see you a bit later.
People looking forward to the party coming up later tonight. There are lots of parties in Sydney tonight.
There's a
major Mardi Gras party. There's also an Indigenous Mardi Gras party. There's plenty of places to go tonight.
And the noise has cranked up. Yeah. The reason that is because AIDS on has joined us. That's the AIDS Council of New South Wales. And their theme for their focus is about maintaining safe sex practices to fight HIV. It's always one of the biggest floats in Mardi Gras. Enormous amount of support. They're letting out streamers into the crowd, which everybody is loving.
Take on one of those organisations that does so much in our community. A huge number of people marching.
They do everything from relationship courses to direct involvement in drug use and safe sex education.
A really big campaign at the moment to get people to test early, test often. Enjoy your life. Now, earlier on, we did have a question about why this is called the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras and not the LGBTIQ Mardi Gras or the queer Mardi Gras.
Yeah.
And I guess that's a pretty good question. There are banners up all over Taylor Square in Sydney where it says we are celebrating lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, intersex pride. So I guess there are those elements of the Mardi Gras. But I think we can always try and do more to be more inclusive of all parts of our community.
It's interesting because a couple of years back they dropped the gay and lesbian and there was an outcry. So changing what makes this event unique and special wasn't going to happen. So it's definitely changed back to the gay and lesbian Mardi Gras. Continues here from Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras with the Heart Foundation coming by with their beautiful rainbow colour heart.
The choreography here is just stunning. Some people...
We should remember these people practice and practice for months to get this right. This is their moment to shine.
People in little red shorts and little red swimmers.
I think they're shorter than shorts. There's speedos involved here. It's got my attention all of a sudden.
Matt, it's been
been wonderful being with you to help bring this broadcast to people around Australia and people with your listening on the radio while here at Mardi Gras. You've been with Emily and Matt Wright.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
From the outrageously adorned to the sassy, satirical and serious, SBS is showcasing the truly incredible 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Hosted by Patrick Abood, Faustina Agoli, Tom Ballard and Magda Szybanski. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Tomorrow 8:30 on SBS. Reflecting diversity.
Joy sponsor.
Down fell the heat. Plop. Sizzling all it touched. It crackled over the lawn and crept into your windows.
Hi, I'm Rick from Happy Tin. Heat goes through your windows like a hot knife through ice cream. Keep your home cool. Stop heat before it enters. Happy Tint your windows and block heat by up to 83%.
Happy Tint your home, your office, your car. Call 1-800-HAPPY-TINT.
Visit happytint.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
I spy with My Vista Eye something beginning with R. Resolution. You've been thinking about laser eye surgery for a while. Well, make a resolution and do something for yourself today. Your initial appointment is free. And should you decide to go ahead, Vista Eyes offers interest-free finance and easy payment options. I spy with My Vista Eye. A new year with no glasses. Phone 1800 5050 49.
Joy sponsor.
Hangmytv.com.au. Hang My TV. That's what we do.
Now you can finally get your TV hung and mounted safely with hangmytv.com.au because that's what we do. Get more space and create a cinema-style experience. Call 1-300-HANG-MY-TV today. hangmytv.com.au because that's what we do.
hangmytv.com.au. Hang My TV. That's what we do.
Joy sponsor.
The world's biggest 90s dance festival is coming to Australia for the first time in March. 90s Mania. Live in concert. Now. Corona.
This is the rhythm of the night.
Culture Beat. CNC Music Factory. 90s Mania. Saturday, March 12, Track Lounge Bar. Ticketmaster.com.au. Relive the biggest hits of the 90s live. Tickets on sale now.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
We're live at the 2016 Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Dean Beck and Shannon Power are with you.
Taylor Square is officially alive. We're about 2 hours deep into this parade. We've just had the Gay and Lesbian Association of Doctors and Dentists. What a sexy kind of group they are, but very important to our health.
We are broadcasting and live streaming online at the Mardi Gras website, mardigras.org.au, and SBS online, sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. And we're also on SBS Digital Radio 3, Joy 94.9, and right around Australia on Community Radio Network.
Still broadcasting here live from Taylor Square with Dean Beck. It's a fantastic time to be here. We've had all the police and ambulance and all of the official people come through. Now the rainbow. Now we're going to cut down to the people who are right in the thick of it. Dylan, Scott, Grace and Josh are right in the centre down there. So let's throw down to our street team at the Mardi Gras.
Hey, what's up, Joy 94.9? I'm standing here with two fabulous ladies. Do you want to introduce yourselves?
Yeah, we love it.
They are loving life right now. They're decked out in all blue, and I'm getting kisses and everything. It is seriously down here becoming one hell of a party on the street. I wish everyone was down here with us. Hey, what's going on with you, Shannon?
Do you mean Shannon as in Chappelle Power? Chappelle is rocking Mardi Gras.
Now we're just seeing the Beyond Blue go past us. Beyond Blue this year is being joined by Victoria's
Sexuality and Gender Commissioner, Rowena Allen. And we're a little bit upset about the carry-on that's been going on with the Safe Schools Coalition.
Absolutely, because I guess Beyond Blue are on the front line of services for depression, mental health issues and anxiety. And as we know, LGBTI people, particularly young LGBTI people, have higher issues with mental health. So Beyond Blue are very passionate about making sure our LGBTI people and our young people are safe and healthy. But they've gone past us. So we're just here. It's all absolutely happening here at the Mardi Gras Parade. And Dean Beck, what do you have to say?
Let's cross down to the street team. Who have we got there?
Hi, it's Grace here and I'm with Byron. How are you?
Very good. It's a very wonderful Mardi Gras, isn't it?
It is, and you guys are looking fabulous. Where are you guys from?
We are from the Rainbow Room, which supports 12-step programs such as AA, NA, and other 12-step programs.
Such amazing times. And you having a great time tonight?
It's great to do it healthy. It's great to do it clean and sober. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a lovely night. Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Grace. Appreciate that. Shannon Carr, we are now seeing Go Past Us, Let's Get Married Australia. Marriage equality is still something we're fighting for here in this country. You're listening to us around the globe.
Now, don't forget, if you are on social media, whether that's Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook, we're at Joy949, but the hashtag is Mardi Gras Joy. Get it trending, people.
And you can follow us and all of the colour removal. We've got photographs going up there online now. We're going to go back to the street team.
All right, we're going to go.
Hi, Deborah. How's your Mardi Gras going?
Awesome.
And I'm here with Rowena. How are you?
I'm having a wonderful time. Happy Mardi Gras, everybody.
Happy Mardi Gras to you too. And where are you guys from today?
Well, I'm marching with Beyond Blue and I'm just trying to highlight the fact that we're overrepresented in mental health issues and, you know, keep your hands off safer schools, please.
Exactly. And you guys are doing such an amazing job. Have a lovely night.
All right, bye now.
Bye. Back to you guys.
Victoria's Sexuality and Gender Commissioner Rowena Allen there joining us live from the Ferry Parade Room.
Well, she certainly knows how to do her parades. And now going past City of Sydney.
I'm glad you said that, not something else.
Oh, you know, I love Rowena a lot. The City of Sydney, of course, is the Sydney Council, who they're very supportive of the LGBTI community, but they have caught a controversy this week, Dean Beck.
Tell me why.
Look to the right of us. This is a very big pink and blue and pink iconic building here in Taylor Square.
It used to be Manicor.
It used to be a very rough nightclub, but they wanted to turn it into an LGBTI museum.
Right.
But Clover Moore, who the Sydney City Mayor, who is parading with us right now.
She's going past as we
she's
speak.
She's going past us. She decided, and they voted to sell it. So it's not going to be an LGBTI museum.
Has she got a better option, has she?
They're just going to sell it and see what happens.
Well, Clover Moore has always been at the forefront of our community in one way or another. Now, Clover is marching with Alex Greenwich. He is in the lower house of the New South Wales.
That's correct. He's in the what we call the House of Representatives in the federal sense. He's an independent MP and he was one of the MPs here in New South Wales that was instrumental in putting together the official government apology to the 78ers.
It has been right at the forefront of putting the LGBTI human rights agenda on the cards as far as politics is concerned in New South Wales.
Do you know what? One of my favourite things of the apology to the 78ers in the New South Wales government was Alex Greenwich said because of the 78ers, the New South Wales state government now has the gayest parliament in the world because there's so many out gay MPs and senators. Isn't that fantastic?
You'd think they'd be a little bit more advanced. Oh, that's a bit harsh, JP.
All right, next up is the Socialist Alliance.
Beautifully done. Look.
Yes, it's a political party dedicated to changing the world through people's involvement in rainbow rights, anti-racist and anti-war campaign. They've been involved for over 11 years, believe it or not, in the marriage equality fight and rallies and queer and intersex and trans rights. So thank you, Socialist Alliance. We appreciate your contribution to the movement.
Now, following the Socialist Alliance, it is the Greens.
Now, leading the Australian Greens Party, of course, is their federal leader, Richard Di Natale. He's one of only two federal leaders to be marching tonight. Of course, Bill Shorten is marching. All right, I can say that, Dean Beck. Thank you very much.
and, of course, the Greens have been lobbying for our community for a long, long time.
And
always had enforced this piece.
Well, of course, and there's Senator Robert Sims, who's their equality and LGBTI spokesperson, is constantly on the front line battling and fighting for LGBTI rights.
Janet Rice is there with her transgender partner as well.
Well, that's fantastic. Good on her and good on her partner. Glad to see them out here at the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
Now, coming up behind them is some first-time marchers in the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
Who might they be?
They are a political flavour. They are indeed the Australian Sex Party. The Sex Party is a social libertarian political party that has championed, supported and advocated for LGBTQ rights from the very, very get-go. Fiona Patton leads their entry in tonight's Mardi Gras parade.
Now, of course, I'm very surprised to hear that they're marching for the first time here in Sydney, because they're always out and loud and proud at the Melbourne Pride rallies, at the Equal Love rallies, at the Marriage Equality rallies. But, you know, I guess they're trying to spread their influence more nationally rather than just in Victoria.
Their Senate candidate, Dr Meredith Joy, is also marching there at the forefront of the Australian Sex Party. And, of course, Fiona is in the Upper House of Victoria.
That's right, which is a fantastic achievement for such a small party. Now, following right behind them is, I guess, one of the major parties in Australia, and that is the Liberal Party following behind the Australian Sex Party. I know that
they're not led by our Prime Minister tonight.
The Prime Minister has left, actually. I've had a sticky beak down to the section where he should have been sitting, and he's not there anymore, so maybe old Malcolm's a bit tired. But I know that the member for Coogee here in New South Wales, Bruce Notley-Smith, who was instrumental, who was key to getting the apology to the 78ers and who led it on behalf of New South Wales government, he's there marching. He told me he'd be dancing to a lot of Madonna tonight, which is appropriate for a Mardi Gras festival. But, yes, there's John Harwin, of course, who is the president of the Legislative, I want to say, Assembly. I might be wrong, but there they are.
And also Tony Abbott's sister.
Christine
well.
Forster, who's a Sydney City Councillor, a representative of the Liberal Party as well.
She told me in an interview a little while back that she was determined to ensure that Clover Moore was no longer elected in the City Hall.
They're not happy with good old mate Clover at the moment after the T2 building fiasco. And what seems to be interesting here is we've had the Liberal Party come through. They seem like a sort of smaller contingent, but I can see the Australian Labor Party.
It's
force.
A sea of red.
All right.
Let's go down to our pit on the parade route and who have we got there?
Fantastic. It's Josh. Now we have Trent here. Trent, tell us, who are you?
I'm Trent Zimmerman. I'm the member for North Sydney in the Australian Parliament and the first openly gay member of the House of Representatives.
Now tell me, Trent, what does Mardi Gras mean to you?
It's just such a fantastic celebration of diversity in our community. It's just really exciting to be here.
Thank you so much, Trent. We won't keep you much longer. Have a fantastic Mardi Gras.
Happy Mardi Gras.
Thanks, guys. Back to you.
All right. Thank you so much, Josh. Now, of course, Trent Zimmerman is not only the first openly gay member of the House of Representatives, he gave his maiden speech earlier this week on Tuesday where he called for an end to homophobia. He called for marriage equality, which is a fantastic way to use his maiden speech in Parliament. And for people who might not be watching online, there's a rogue Bronwyn Bishop flying in a bedazzled helicopter. But forget that, Bill Shorten's here.
Ronnie takes a ride. Now, Bill Shorten has created a traffic jam as the cameras have descended upon him. It is the
Rainbow Labour section.
Rainbow Labour section, indeed. But is it the first time an opposition leader has marched into
the Mardi Gras? So, Bill Shorten officially is the first leader of a major party, the federal major party,
right,
to ever march in a Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. He's joined by Deputy Leader Tanya Plibersek. Anthony Albanese is there. They've caused a traffic jam for a reason, because they are creating history tonight.
Tanya Plibersek, her own electorate, is in this very region.
She is in Sydney.
Yeah. And they have got A sea of red. Rainbow Labour is, of course, behind me. Little Bronny takes a ride.
Good on her. Little old Bronny.
But the cameras really have to see the plot. Tanner's going to say Bill Short and the leaders.
For people who might not be watching online the live stream at MardiGras.org.au, just to describe what's happening, we're at the corner of Taylor Square where the parade turns from Oxford Street into Flinders Street. The Rainbow Labour Party has come to a complete halt because everybody wants to talk to Bill Shorten. Because as we said, he wants to create history. Patrick Aboud from SBS is in the thick of it. He's down there. It might be a while before we see the next float, the way things are looking, Dean Beck.
You are listening to Joy 94.9's live broadcast, streaming online at MardiGras.org.au and online at sbs.com.au/MardiGras.
Now, one of the most interesting floats this year, which follows the Rainbow Labour float, two after the Rainbow float, my apologies, is the Muslims against homophobia. They're the Muslims for progressive values, but they put out a call to action. They asked for some money for people to support them because they're like, there's a lot of people who are Muslim or Middle Eastern or Arabic or whatever their backgrounds are who aren't able to be out, and we don't think that's good enough. So the Muslims Against Homophobia put all of their pennies together so that they could march in this parade and call for equality for all people to be able to live freely, whether they're LGBTI, no matter their religious background, and they have garnered a lot of attention. I have to say, when I did the story in the Star Observer, it probably was one of the most read stories online this year, the Muslims Against Homophobia story.
Have been assembling and getting themselves together. I'm with Brendan and Hayley. Thank you for joining us. Brendan, tell us a little bit about your
slowly but surely, and I think it's the great work of, for example, my editor, Elias Sharp, Patrick Aboud. The more that people speak about it, the more people won't have to hide who they are, and they can be their true selves, which is fantastic. We'll get there eventually.
It is just one of the many multicultural experiences in 2016 at Mardi Gras Parade. A huge celebration of cultural diversity as well as LGBTI diversity and pride.
So we are getting into the religious section of the parade, and coming up after the Muslims Against Homophobia, of course, is the Sydney Shambhala Meditation Group, and they take its name from a legendary kingdom famous for being an enlightened society. And the network today brings together people of all ages, from all walks of life, who are interested in exploring their own minds. So they teach about human dignity, and they're captured in the four dignities: the tiger, the lion, the Garuda, and dragon. And they're here to support the LGBTI world.
Very, very supportive of that, which is lovely to see. Behind them, we have the Jewish contingent audience today. Let Your Light Shine is the theme of their entry. It is the Diana was organisation was conceived in 1999 as a cooperation between local lesbian and gay Jewish groups to enter a combined float in the 2000 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Shortly after that, the group formalised and agreed to operate in order to provide outreach and support for their community.
So fantastic, and it's great to see the diverse Jewish community in itself coming together to support the LGBTI community. Now, do you know one of Sydney's very own Jewish members, Bruce Pollack, was awarded an Australian Order of Australia Medal, and I'm going to get it wrong, but he was one of the few LGBTI people in this year's Australia Day honours to receive an award, and that's Mr. Bruce Pollack. I don't know if he's marching tonight, but he's a very prominent member of Sydney's LGBTI and Jewish community.
I mentioned Catholics before.
Yeah, didn't you just?
Following the Jewish contingent, there is the Acceptance Sydney for Gay and Lesbian Catholics. We'll go down and see what Scott is doing down there on the break.
Yeah, hi, I've got Linda here. Linda, where are you from?
From England originally, but we're all the Sydney Shambhala Meditation Group.
And what brings you here? What are you marching for tonight?
Oh, we have a lot of gay and lesbian friends, and we just want to let everybody know that anyone's welcome in Shambhala. So it's a Buddhist meditation group that's very small. We just set it up. Everyone's welcome.
So it's all about diversity.
Yep, absolutely.
Happy Mardi Gras. And I don't know, first of all, what you are wearing is amazing. How heavy is that?
It's all styrofoam.
Now, what is it?
I'm a Garuda.
There we are. Happy Mardi Gras. Have a great night.
Thank you so much.
Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Scott. There with a Garuda.
Garuda, mate.
Garuda.
Garuda. So we've got the Catholics slowly meandering. I mean, you know what? Good on them, because it wouldn't be a very easy to be a gay and lesbian Catholic person.
Shannon, the Catholic Acceptance Organisation was established in 1972. Acceptance Sydney has been providing safe and spiritual place for LGBT Catholics, their family and friends, and affirming their Catholic faith whilst being LGBTIQ.
Good on them, and good on them for sticking firm to their faith despite recent controversies. Now, if you are listening to us online, whether that's on SBS Radio Digital 3, on the Community Radio Network, or on joy.org.au, or if you're watching us live on the online stream on mardigras.org.au, make sure that you social media us, whether that's on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook. That's at Joy949, the hashtag that we're trying to rock the socks off tonight.
Well, you want trending, don't you?
I love trending. Mardi Gras Joy. It's pretty easy. Get on to it. Now, following the Catholic group, the Acceptance Sydney for Gay and Lesbian Catholics, the United Network, who are a very pivotal and important organisation for the LGBTI world.
Now, momentum is, of course, the theme of Mardi Gras 2016.
Yep.
Momentum towards justice is the theme that the United Network have taken on board. And we've still got a little way to go.
Now, it's very interesting. Last week, I went to a forum hosted by the Reverend Margaret Maiman, who is the head of Pitt Street Uniting Church here in Sydney. And it was about what can the LGBTI community do more for LGBTI refugees. It was fantastic. The Human Rights Commissioner Gillian Triggs was speaking, and a whole range of people spoke about the issues that LGBTI refugees and asylum seekers face. So they're very passionate about that cause, but it's great to see the Uniting Network get out there and speak very openly about the issues that they care deeply about.
A little response to the issues regarding the Safe Schools program and that sort of stuff. Last week, we saw a huge meeting in Melbourne, over 300 people get together to try and counter what's going on politically in the space. So the New South Wales Teachers Union are forming a response to the LGBTI issues, and that's on Monday night.
I have to go to it. I thought I might have a couple of days recovery, but no, in my role at Star Observer, I have to go and do a bit more work, but that's fine. Whatever it helps for our rainbow community, whatever work we can do, we are proud to do. You're listening to Joy 94.9, streaming on digital SBS Radio 3, Dean Beck and Shannon Power. What is up next?
Well, it's nice to see that the Sydney Queer Atheists are part of the religious organisations that have featured here today.
Why not?
Now, the Queer Atheists is a community organisation for queer atheists that are non-heterosexual, funnily enough. And they aim to bring queer atheists together so they can understand about their particular bent in life.
The atheists would have wrapped up the religious portion of the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras for 2016, but no, we have the Wayside Chapel, whose float this year, the theme is Soar Together. Now, the Wayside Chapel has provided unconditional love, care and support for people on and around the streets of King's Cross since 1964, which we know has been quite a rough area in Sydney for such a long time. And thousands of people, many whom are marginalised and dispossessed, visit Wayside for their assistance, including LGBTI people.
Now we've got Twitter here, Tweet for Diversity. What's our hashtag?
Hashtag Mardi Gras Joy.
We want to see trending on Twitter with that one. And we're celebrating diversity this year's Mardi Gras Parade. We've got behind them Australian Marriage Equality.
Now, everybody recognises Australian Marriage Equality. They're the team headed up by Rodney Crim, their national director, who is day in and day out lobbying and fighting to see the marriage equality issue once and for all be decided so that people of any sexuality can be married.
We will win is the name of their entry. Now, we've got someone down in the parade route. So who's got that?
It's Grace here. What are your names, girls? Sophie and Laura. And what are you doing here tonight? We've been together for about a year and our friend works at Twitter, so we're on the Twitter float. And is this your first Mardi Gras?
Yeah.
Yes, first one together. You guys look amazing. And what does this mean to you tonight?
All we want is equality, you know? Like, that's our biggest thing. So it's just really great to see everyone out here tonight.
It's amazing. And this year is our year, equality for all. Yeah. Have a great Mardi Gras, girl.
Yeah.
Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Grace. Now, NRL, let's think.
Now, I've lived in Queensland and Sydney. I know I'm originally from Melbourne, but I can explain this. NRL means rugby league.
Yeah, keep going.
Even though I'm from Melbourne, I know this. So that's the sport that the Rabbitohs do and...
Right, okay, this is where I take over. So...
We're going to go back down to Josh on the ground, and he's got someone from Australian Marriage Equality.
Hi guys, it's Josh here. Now I've just witnessed something. Two guys. What are your names?
Jai
and Richard.
And Richard, Jai and Richard, happy Mardi Gras. Now I just witnessed you two kissing each other as we walked along here. Now how long have you been together?
2.5 years now.
That is insane. Congratulations, guys, and I wish you all the best. What does Mardi Gras mean to you both?
It means being proud of what we've achieved, but also making sure that people remember what we still have to achieve. And this year, it's more important than ever. The marriage equality debate, the safe schools debate, there's a lot of stuff stirring up that we thought was solved, and it's just really important to remind people that we need to be treated the same as everyone else.
Thank you so much, and we wish you all the best. Happy Mardi Gras, guys.
Thank you very much, Josh. Now, rhythm is a dancer. Now, we have the Paulini Rhythm Brazil. And Rhythm Brazil in extraordinary, colourful, Rio de Janeiro-inspired...
we're back on air. Sorry, yes. I was telling people off for getting our broadcast face. Paulini, she's a former Australian idol. She's dancing here with Rio 2016 Birds of Paradise. You know, there's nothing like being at a parade without having a bit of Brazilian Rio de Janeiro carnival action.
Look, it is straight out of the Rio carnival. There's the feathers and not much else, really.
Brazil, despite it being a very fervently Catholic country, is very pro-gay, very pro-marriage equality. I'm not sure if it's legal there yet, but you can definitely live openly gay and proud in Brazil. So, welcome.
When you wiggle your hips and dance, is it like that? Or?
Yeah, I've actually been to Rio and I've performed at the Rio Carnival, so whatever, Dean.
Yeah, right.
I can dance like that.
They are so beautiful and so colourful. It's so, so much.
They are colourful. And I can confirm that Brazil does have recognition of same-sex marriage, so I love Brazil. Viva Brazil!
Many of the South American countries do that.
Uruguay, Argentina, Brazil, that's it, actually. Come on, Australia, catch
come
up.
Australia, get with it.
All right, following after that, some very important members of the community.
Is
who are
this
they?
How you suck at the sea?
I don't know what that means, Dean.
Lifesavers. These are lifesavers with pride.
No, that's definitely the Australian Olympian and Paralympians coming up next. Do we see any gold medalists? We see rowing. We see... Go on, Dean.
This is the Daniel Kowalski entry, is it?
I presume Daniel Kowalski's there, swimmer, out, gay, proud, gay man, cycling. So what they're doing, the Australian Olympians and Paralympians have signs up for the sport that they participate in, much like they do in the opening ceremonies, but for countries. So it's great to see so many athletes from a diverse range of sports flying their gay pride very proudly. I don't see Ian Thorpe, though.
I'm back on the right page, and I'm with you. If we explain the beautiful flames that have been flying around here, tonight, behind as a backdrop to the SBS broadcast, they've got colourful flames.
Rainbow flames. They're very hot because we're quite close to them, but they look stunning.
So, yeah, they're flames. I don't know how they do that.
As a natural Melbournean, the next float that comes past sort of gives me a bit of grief. I don't like to see them because they often beat us, and that's the Sydney Convicts Rugby Union Club. So before I complain about the Sydney Convicts, I'm going to throw down to the street team and take it away, guys.
Yeah, hi, it's Scott here, and I've got somebody from the wrestling team, is that right?
So my name's Kyla Bremner from the Australian Olympic Committee float. I was a wrestler in Beijing, and we're here to represent all of our gay, lesbian, transgender, queer, and we're having a fantastic...
And everybody else. What was it like in Beijing?
It was fantastic. It was almost as good as this.
Almost as good as this. Well, happy Mardi Gras.
Happy Mardi Gras to everyone.
Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Scott. You heard it first. Mardi Gras is more fun than the Olympics.
Well, because they probably can't dance and take life very seriously as an Olympian.
Not in Beijing. Now, we were talking about the convicts. They are Sydney's gay rugby team.
Yes, they did take out the Bingham Cup recently. Hopefully the Melbourne Chargers smashed them at this year's Bingham Cup.
I tell you what, the Sydney convicts are the world's best when it comes to gay rugby. Now let's go down to our pit on the parade route and who have we got from the convicts?
Hey, it's Dylan here and I'm with Stishy from the convicts. Mate, what's going on tonight for Mardi Gras in your world?
Oh, mate, we're just here, you know, representing the Team Sydney and the rugby boys. We're having an amazing night, awesome crowd.
Now, I just want to say, Sydney Convicts, you guys seem to smash it in terms of local queer rugby. I'm curious, like, how much training do you go into this?
Oh, there's lots of preparation beforehand. So obviously we've got our trials working out who's going to be playing first, second, third. And then we'll practice, you know, four times a week before the big day. So yeah, bring it home.
Awesome stuff. Well, I won't keep you any longer, Sitsy. You have a great night. Happy Mardi Gras. Oh, God, this is getting hot down here.
So who do we have here?
I'm Robin.
Robin, how are you enjoying Mardi Gras tonight?
I'm having a fabulous time with the Sydney Silverbacks, the Harbour City Wrestling Club.
And why are you marching tonight?
Well, we're marching for marriage equality and gay rights, and we're just marching to show how fabulous it is to be homosexual in Sydney.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for that. Now, you are listening to Joy 94.9's live broadcast in conjunction with SBS Digital Radio 3. And we're web streaming online at mardigras.org.au and at sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. You're with Dean Beck and Shannon Power. Coming up next, Adam Richards and Greta will be with you for more of the parade.
The world's biggest 90s dance festival is coming to Australia for the first time in March. 90s Mania. Live in concert. Corona. Culture Beat. CNC Music Factory. 90s Mania. Saturday, March 12, Track Lounge Bar. Ticketmaster.com.au. Relive the biggest hits of the 90s live. Tickets on sale now.
Joy sponsor.
From the outrageously adorned to the sassy, satirical and serious, SBS is showcasing the truly incredible 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Hosted by Patrick Abood, Faustina Agoli, Tom Ballard and Magda Szybanski. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Tomorrow 8:30 on SBS. Reflecting diversity.
Joy sponsor.
It's the hottest theatre show on the planet, and it's coming to Melbourne. Velvet, the disco, circus, burlesque extravaganza. It's raining men. With a star-studded cast, including the legendary diva, Marsha Hines. Playing at the Cooper's Malt House for a limited season only. Opens March 23. Book your tickets now. Velvet. Welcome to Wonderland. Boogie Wonderland. Joy sponsor.
I spy with my Vista Eye something beginning with L. LASIK.
Hi, I'm Dr. Rick Wolf. LASIK is the most popular form of vision correction, with over 31 million cases performed worldwide. 90% of Vista Eye patients have LASIK, used to treat short-sightedness, long-sightedness and astigmatism. And with our advanced technology, LASIK can now take less than 15 minutes as an in-house procedure.
I spy with my Vista Eye, your free appointment. Phone 1800 50 50 49.
Joy sponsor.
Luke, I am your father's new boyfriend. We met online 6 months ago. We share many common interests, like pottery, and he's very supportive of my work and ambitions. He's the stars to my galaxy.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Taylor Square. This is Adam Richard and Greta Larkins with you from Joy 94.9. Also coming across on SBS On Demand, SBS Digital 3, and the Community Radio. We are very, very excited. Things are moving very quickly now, aren't they, Greta?
They are indeed. We are really amongst it right now, Adam.
We're knee deep.
We are knee deep at the Sydney Mardi Gras. We're knee deep in rainbows. We're knee deep in glitter. We're knee deep in good old-fashioned fun.
Yes, and people are very, very lucky that I have only just arrived back at the Broadcasting Centre. Thank you very much to Dean Beck and Shannon Power for the last 30 minutes. And I was a little overwhelmed by the water polo.
Oh, come now. now. We were actually standing together when they went past, and you were, it was rather a thrill, I think.
And I think it's about to happen again with Team Sydney here.
Now, this is a good-looking bunch of human beings. They should rename it. It's not the Sydney Mardi Gras. It's the Sydney Very Good-Looking People Parade.
It's the Sydney Very Good-Looking People Parade.
Now, here's a sign I agree with. AFL says no to homophobia. Love it.
Oh, absolutely. We've got Scott. Now, who have you got down there, Scott?
Well, I've got somebody from the Bush Lemons. Who have I got?
My name's Susan from the Bush Lemons.
Susan, what's your message tonight?
Oh, have fun, love each other, and go bushwalking a lot with the Bush Lemons.
That sounds like an absolutely a hoot.
It is. It is. It's a really lovely thing, walking with a bunch of women in the beautiful Australian bush.
How many are there of you tonight?
I think there must be at least 40 or 50, which is probably about a quarter of our number.
Awesome. Well, have a lovely night.
Thank you very much. You too. Happy
Mardi Gras. Thank you, Scott. That was the Bush Lemons Lesbian Bushwalking Group.
Well, they're getting an awful lot of walking practice tonight, aren't
they,
Adam?
Are. But there's not much bush. Well, it's been how the night ends up.
So we currently have the AFL Women up on the screen, which is, look, I've got to be honest with you, I have a very good kick in football.
Yes.
So I think I should be out there amongst them.
Well, I think you should as well. Although then I would be standing here talking to myself.
This is
very
true.
Boring for me. But yes, good on the AFL Women for walking tonight. They're absolutely amazing. Who have we got coming down now in this huge bump? It is mature age gay.
Now, come on, how old do you have to be a mature age gay?
I think 29.
Oh, well, I'm in.
We do have a footballer now down on the street. Who have we got?
Hey, I'm with Natasha here from the Women's AFL. Natasha, and you've got a friend here as well. What's
your
name?
Yes, Ebs. Hello, my name's Ebs. I'm a lesbian.
Oh, hello, I'm a homosexual as well.
Congratulations.
Oh, it's all for us tonight. Now, tell me about...
It's catchy.
Oh, it's contagious.
Happy Christmas.
Gay Christmas, yeah, indeed.
Yes.
Now, tell me about Women's AFL.
Well, this is the second time that the AFL have officially sponsored and supported our march. But in Sydney, we've got a league of 12 teams, Women's AFL, and it's growing. Oh, it's growing. It's the fastest growing sport in Australia.
Absolutely. Look, it was a pleasure talking to you.
Yes, great. Happy Mardi Gras.
Thank you so much. Wow, it is getting crazy down here. What's it like upstairs?
Oh, it is crazy here. We just had fireworks going from my ear.
Now, Adam, I don't want a name drop, but I just spotted a friend on the screen. So keep your eyes peeled, because it really is people from the community out there taking part and getting involved. They're
excellent.
People you know and people you love.
And which group are they from?
Oh, now you've got me. But they appear to have, well, look, I could see a lot of rainbows. So they're keeping with the theme of the night, and I appreciate that.
The Jean Regine, who is... They're a roller derby group by the look of it.
Getting out there on the skates is one way to do it, that's for sure.
Our Josh is down with one of the roller skaters. Hey, Josh.
Hey, guys. It's nuts down here. Who do we have?
Hi, my name's Ellie Zamons, and I'm with Honor Roll. Happy Mardi Gras.
Fantastic. Thanks so much. Back to you guys.
Oh, bless.
Honor Roll. Heavens above.
Get it?
I do. Only just, though. We're taking a look now at disability under the mirror ball.
Oh, amazing. So people with disability in Australia are marching, and the message they want to get across is that when they talk about disability under the mirror ball, they think of everyone under the same mirror ball, regardless of disability.
And they have brought their own mirror balls, so they are on top of it tonight.
Well, you know, be my own mirror ball, I say, if you want to have a good time.
I think so. If you're not wearing the mirror ball, hang it above your head. In fact, that should be a Mardi Gras tradition.
It
if you see
be.
A mirror ball, have a kiss underneath it, I say.
Like, so it is Gay Christmas.
It is Gay Christmas. We've got our own mistletoe replacement.
A pass under the mirror ball.
You and I, maybe not.
Maybe.
Okay.
Now we see a flame of pink coming down the street, followed by some gold.
Well, I just read the words, and now block any children's ears, snatch and grab.
Snatch and grab, gold momentum is the name of this particular block.
And it says snatch and grab provides a variety of safe spaces and events to support the young queer and lesbian people of Sydney and Melbourne. I love it.
Oh, we love anything that's bi city.
We are! Plenty of bisexuals, now we have bi city.
We've got bi city safe spaces.
This is what we want.
The snatch and grab.
Snatch and grab. It doesn't sound as safe as maybe they purport. But it does sound like you'll have a good time.
It does sound like a good. Well, it's a safe space for young people.
Oh, look at the crowds. It's filling out here tonight in Sydney. It's 24 minutes to 10. The weather is beautiful.
Yes, it is. This is the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. You are on Joy 94.9, as well as SBS On Demand and the Mardi Gras website. And the computer network.
Starting to hear some Beyonce spilling out over the crowd. She would definitely be a crowd favourite here.
It wouldn't be Mardi Gras without Beyonce.
It would not. And we were talking earlier about the gay classics, weren't we? We have a snatch and grab person down with our street team. Let's see what they're snatching and or grabbing.
What is snatching and grabbing?
Hey, I'm down here in the street with Grace. Grace, what's going on?
Nothing much, just celebrating Mardi Gras.
There's just a total nonchalant time. You're wearing a really rad outfit. You look all like a steampunk and NRL. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's kind of like, well, our theme was gold theme, year 3000, who run the world, girls. And, you know, I feel like it embodied exactly what we're about.
Well, I think right now you are Sasha Fierce. Tell me, how long did it take to get all glittered up?
Mate, shredding for Mardi Gras, it's a thing.
Oh, shredding for Mardi Gras. We'll start that hashtag later. Hey, thank you so much for having a talk with me.
No worries. Thank you.
Happy Mardi Gras.
Happy Mardi Gras.
Awesome stuff. It is so cool down here. Seriously, what's going on upstairs, guys?
Well, we have just had the Hoop Force Australia, which they're a collective of hula hoop dancers, believe it or not.
And they were dancing up a storm. The level of coordination that you actually need to audition to be involved in Mardi Gras. You've got to be able to do group dance. You've got to be able to get in formation. You need to be able to get amongst it.
Well, speaking of formation, Dr. Mark's Marching Academy is going past now. Their float is speed races. Nothing can stop us.
Sparkling pom-poms are plenty right now down there at Mardi Gras. It is gold magic.
And it appears to be clothing optional as well.
Well, Adam, I wanted to talk to you about this. That is a little bit of a, you know, a secret theme tonight. Put it on, take it off. It doesn't matter.
Well, I can never tell whether someone has got glistening abs or they're covered in glitter, but everyone looks amazing.
Don't they just? And when I say put it on, I definitely mean put on condoms. It's the clothes that are optional, not the safe sex, you guys.
The clothes do seem to be very, very optional. Now, coming up after Dr. Barber's Marching Academy,
Oh, you're picking favourites now.
I love it. I have not worked for them before. I put a snack on their Mr. Bear Sydney.
Oh, heavens. I had no idea we had such an award.
Oh, yeah. It's totally a beauty pageant for heavy set area men. This is what I love about the bear community.
I think I fit a few of that criteria, to be honest with you, Adam. Well, look, any of the floats, the BYO ticker tapes, are my favourite. What fun.
Exactly. Amazing. The Harbour City Bear Festival. They are shooting, it looks like dry ice out into the crowd.
Oh, it does indeed. Here they are in all their bearded glory. Adam's perked up now.
Oh, I'm very excited now. I do love the Harbour City Bear.
Oh, how fantastic. I hope Mr. Bear, I hope he's on the float right now.
Oh, he must be. Yes, there he is. He's in charge of the car.
Oh, what an honour.
And look, there's Mr. Bear with a big sash on. You can always tell Mr. Bear is always wearing the leather sash.
Oh, aren't you? We're all learning things tonight, me in particular.
And he's seriously, like, one of the most beautiful moments of my life as I presented the sash. And, you know, the announcement was made that Mr. Runner-Up is. There were tears, there were flowers, there were little teddy bears handed out. It was beautiful.
I love it. It's a piece of magic here happening right now in Sydney. It's just fantastic out there.
Look at the Harbour City Bears.
Oh, Adam's giving them all a wave. He's saying hi to his friends down in the parade. Take a look at that. It's just so nice to see the smiling faces. It's so nice to see the joy in the community because that's what this is about. It's a fun night and it's a time to celebrate.
It is a night to celebrate. Now we're up to the Sydney Leather Pride Club here.
nipple section of the show.
It is the hard nipple section of the show.
Because if the temperature drops anymore, we're going to see an awful lot of them out there tonight. And if that's what you're into, get amongst it, I say. Here we go.
We do have one of the Harvest City Bears down on the street now. We're across down. Hello.
Oh, we've lost our Harvest City Bears.
Bear.
They're probably catching up with the Leather Association.
Well, they're probably banged into each other and we're seeing them for the rest of the night.
Now, we're taking a look at a cage right now because it wouldn't be Mardi Gras without some cages and some masks.
Yes, this is Pub Pride Down Under. This is for people who like to dress up as a leather dog.
I've always wanted a dog, and now I know I have another way to approach it.
Oh, yeah, you can get a dog who can also wash the dishes for you.
Oh, I'd love that, because I like to think I'm a dog whisperer, but if I just have to talk to a human in a mask, that's an awful lot easier, isn't it?
They're more obedient than an actual dog.
Yeah, that's right. There's no language barrier.
They clean up after themselves.
Do they sleep on the end of the bed and keep you comfortable?
If you tell them to.
Oh, I love it. Now, look, who would have thought tonight would be so educational, but here we are.
Oh, some cage dancing. If you are watching online, you can see some cage dancing in the Sydney Leather Pride Association. Getting very, very excited there in the back of the truck.
That's at sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. And you can see all of the things. You've just missed the cage.
Oh, you've missed several cats.
Now, here are your people. I think you got a kiss from one of these people. Oz Furs are about to come onto the screen.
Yes, one year I was on the street reporting for, I believe, Channel 10. And I made out with one of the furries. Kangaroo came up and gave me quite a passion.
Now, that's the spirit of it, though, I think so. If you're not going to get a kiss at Mardi Gras, when are you going to get a kiss? The best part is you can kiss whoever you want.
Yes.
I mean, it's the only night of the year you're allowed to, so you might as well get down there.
If you want to kiss a kangaroo, then kiss a kangaroo, I say. But Oz Furs, they're floating in Red Rocket, and this year they're blasting off into the future, riding their Red Rocket Utopian-style supersonic.
This is my favourite part. They're celebrating the energy and creativity of the furry community.
Yes, they're very creative, the furry community.
If you don't know much about the furry community, I'd say get on the internet, have a quick look, it's pretty good fun.
I'd say go and get on the internet.
Switch on your safe search and then have a little look.
Put the safe search on before you get on the internet.
Now, yeah. How's this? We have a rhinoceros. Who's about
indeed.
To appear. I did not see that come. Oh, it's the Taronga Conservative Society Australia.
Oh, the Taronga Conservation Society. Taronga Zoo, one of the premier zoos in Australia. Possibly some of the best real estate in Sydney. Owned by monkeys.
It's true. Many animals with a very good view.
And bless the Taronga Society for coming down here with their paper mache rhinoceros. Looking amazing. Oh, and we've got a pride of lions and everything.
There we go. Our Taronga Zoo people now dancing on screen. Celebrating animals. Celebrating wildlife, if you will. And it is wild
it is
out there on the streets right
there.
Now.
I think we need a few things to keep people in line.
Now, that's not a bad idea for next year, Adam. We need to get on the committee, don't we?
We do. We need to organise some actions.
We're coming up with all the ideas up here tonight. Now, there's a rainbow flag if you haven't seen one already. And why is that? Because we're at the Sydney Mardi Gras. There's lots of clues. I'm picking up all of them.
We are at the Sydney Mardi Gras. We're broadcasting from Taylor Square in Sydney. This is Joy 94.9 SBS On Demand. And for the Mardi Gras website, if you're watching the footage,
tradies right there.
It is the gay trade.
And as they say, pure and simple, there are gay people everywhere, including trades and services. It's true.
Well, I have an ex that was a tradie. He used to go off to work every day and find his best. And I didn't find that at all.
Well, that's not bad to have a look at first thing in the morning, is it? I imagine.
Especially because he was leaving the house. And kept messing it up when he got home.
We
do have a trainee on the street. I wonder if it's the one that's holding the sign that says free tug. Who have we got down there?
We're in the street. street with Jaden.
This is fucking great.
Oh, wowee. Tell me, Jaden, are you in?
Straight.
So you want a straight ally?
Off work.
Excellent stuff. Jaden, you have a lovely night. Thank you for being an amazing straight ally.
Yeah.
Oh, happy Mardi Gras.
Mardi Gras.
Go, back to you guys.
Thank you to our foul-mouthed ace rating.
You know what? I shouldn't have been surprised by that, but I was.
Well, in all seriousness, we have trouble with the taps back in my house in Melbourne, so if he wants to come over, we desperately need him.
Yes, I need my walls fixing.
Now, look at all of that ticker tape. The streets are coming alive out here in Sydney. We've got dancing, we've got spirit, we've got headpieces, we've got clapping.
We've got everything going on.
Great de Sol out there now.
At the moment, the Rail de Sol community summer band is marching down the street. And as you can see, there's very vigorous dancing.
Adam, I don't mean to gloat, but I can samba.
You can?
I can. And I can't do it right now on this chair I'm standing on, because that would definitely be a hazard. But I promise I will pull out my moves a little bit later on.
Oh, they look spectacular in their little devil heads down there.
Isn't that fantastic? They've got bought their BYO percussion instruments, says the samba people. I love it.
And look, spectacular outfit. And it seems very fitting that this year there's so many Latin things, given that it is the year that the Olympics are going to Rio.
That's right.
And it is Mardi Gras, which happens in Rio.
It does indeed. They definitely hold the essence of parades in Mardi Gras. So looking forward to that opening ceremony, if I do say so myself.
Now on screen, if you're watching, you can see devilishly Tasmanian. It's a Tasmanian float of LGBTIQ members and family and friends who wanted to take part in this year's parade. We do have a devilish Tasmanian on the street right now. Let's pop down to the hello.
Hi, this is Scott, and who have I got here?
Hi, I'm Pete from Tassie.
Pete, welcome to Sydney.
Thank you.
How many times have you come up here?
For Mardi Gras, this is our third.
And what's your group all about?
Well, it's about sharing what's important about Australia and diversity.
Awesome. Well, have a happy Mardi Gras.
Thanks, guys.
Back to you guys.
Oh, thank you so much, Scott. The Northern Territory AIDS and Hepatitis Council are currently on screen in a gigantic pearl. Pearl, of course, a big industry up there in the Northern Territory.
Ah, I see now. Oh, I love those through lines. You know I like when it gets a little bit educational. You're taking a look at that right now, and the beautiful emerald tones that they're wearing. And they see Darwin as the jewel. I love it.
Yeah, Darwin is spectacular. And the pearl in there is, it is quite a spectacular.
They are exhibiting rare individuals, just like their rare pearls. I love it. I see what they did. Bless them.
Bless them. But yes, absolutely amazing. And look, there's a lovely woman there dancing in the middle of her pearl shell.
Oyster. Well, the world is her oyster. She's taken that very literally tonight. But you can't blame her. In fact, the world is the LGBTQI plus community's oyster tonight here in Sydney.
Oh, there is a plus.
There is a plus. Everyone's involved.
The next one coming along are the Canberra Queens Capital. Canberra.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, I know.
Don't be a drag. Just be a queen. Here's what they have to say. We are gay. Get over it. Well, that's to the point, isn't it?
Well, we have seen several representatives of Canberra News. I'm at Melbourne Turnbull up on the balcony. Bill Shorten wandering down the middle of the road.
I spotted the Greens a little bit earlier. Canberra is here. All of them are here, basically.
Canberra is overrepresented.
Now, this float has bought their own tree.
Oh, bless them. We've had the South Australian Mardi Gras Committee and now the Gay Social Wollongong. The gong of water tree with them, bless them. And now, look at this gigantic flag.
Oh, look at that tree.
The gong.
Isn't that beautiful? The effort that so many of these floats have gone to tonight is just divine.
And it's great to see, Wollongong, it's a fair stretch down the road. They don't have to make a short trip to get here.
Hopefully in the float.
Oh, that would be lovely to see the tree.
A little bit of Priscilla, Queen of the Desert right there.
A couple of drag queens and a tree.
Yeah. Well, that's what you want to see on the road up to Sydney, I think.
On the way from the Gulf. Less than from coming at now.
We've got some synchronised dancing, Adam. Oh. This is what we're all about tonight. A bit too much clothing for our taste, though. Take it off, you guys. Keep the dancing up, though, because we love it.
Oh, we do love it. We've had Miss Wagga Wagga has been walking along the street. She just wants to say happy Mardi Gras, followed up by Capital Queers, Holding the Man. It's a camera-based community group that exists for the purpose of bringing people together with the opportunity to march in the Sydney Gardens.
I love that.
And so they're reenacting Holding the Man, the infamous and wonderful film that we've been able to film this year. Absolutely wonderful film as well. So good on them for reenacting that. It was quite a spectacular band. Now, coming along now on the back of the truck, I believe this might be Gay City Australia. I think people are just making up names to get in the parade.
You know what their motto is, Adam? Less is more. This is your kind of float, I think, right now.
That just comes when it comes to clothing.
Yes, that's right. And it's not tidy whities, it's tidy rainbows.
Oh, so many rainbows.
So many rainbows, and I am loving it.
This is quite spectacular. They've got light-up umbrellas going on. We've got, look at this.
Oh, heavens above. Now, that is a close-up of something.
That is a very big close-up.
Now, here we have an umbrella that's got a simple message. Gay.
Gay. We've got someone down the street from who knows where. Hello.
Hi, guys. It's Josh. Now, I have one of my dear, dear friends here, Charity Seals. Now, Charity is someone very special. Charity, what did you win recently?
I have no idea what you just said, to be honest.
What have you just won recently?
I won Miss Gay Australia 2015. It was last year, but I'm still clinging on to hope that no one remembers.
Definitely. Now, what does Mardi Gras mean to you?
This Mardi Gras means to me remembering all the suffering that we've had in the past and celebrating moving forward, breaking down barriers and building bridges to a more inclusive community.
Fantastic, Cherry. Now, your costume looks absolutely amazing. How much time and effort have you put into it?
I put in at least 3 weeks, 1 hour a night, sweating, drinking, labouring, drinking. A lot of drinking, is what I'm saying.
Thank you so much, Charity, and happy Mardi Gras. Back to you guys.
Oh, thank you very much. So much. We've got Tropical Fruits who've just gone past. They're from the Northern Rivers of New South Wales, which is a beautiful part of the world. We're talking, you know, your bar and face, your runs, your cans.
Oh, nice. What are they doing here? No, just kidding. They're here for the fun of it, aren't they?
They're just here for one big night. They're all going back to their glamorous lifestyle.
That's right. We've got some swimming on the screen now. Oh. I get it. It's synchronized swimming, but it's synchronized dancing. And this is from a home sharing service, a hotel service.
Oh, bless them.
That you would know by the better name of Airbnb. Isn't that nice? It's so good to see businesses, community groups, everyone coming together to be proud.
Everyone's being proud.
The levels of pride tonight, if anything, are starting to get a bit much.
Oh, I know.
No, I'm kidding. And the gorgeous big flag is still blowing overhead, except right now it is full of ticker tape.
Oh, ticker tape spewing out of the roof of the house stuck on the back of the truck in front of us.
Big shout out to the Sydney Council, and I suspect a whole bunch of volunteers will do the clean-up job.
Oh, it is a huge clean-up job as well.
They're going to be out there for at least a week and a half, and then they've got my bedroom to do after that.
One of my favourite things that I'm loving is that the lights are still going on. The traffic lights. Well, we've got someone in the street, apparently. Who's there?
Hey, I'm here with Inika. What's going on tonight?
What are you doing here tonight? Who are you marching with?
You know, I'm marching with the Lismore folk, and we are Queer As. We're a new cultural online platform for the LGBTIQ community.
That is phenomenal.
Connecting the queer world.
Tell me more.
Oh, come and join us. We're connecting us all. It's very exciting. It's a new cultural online platform for the queer community.
I think it's fantastic what you've got with your umbrella with the neon lights. Tell me about that setup.
Oh, well, we're just joining them. We're everywhere. Queer As is everywhere, and we're part of this crew right now.
Well, Queer As, I'm having such a sensational time with you.
Excellent. Me too. I love you.
I love you more. Oh, my God. I think I just found a date later on. I need to throw back to the studio before it gets too heavy down here.
Oh, I wish we were in a studio. We're standing out on a giant platform in the middle of the street at Taylor Square for the Sydney Gay Lesbian Mardi Gras, broadcasting on Joy 94.9, SBS Digital, SBS On Demand. website as well as the community network. We are going to be leaving you very soon. Coming up, we will have Matt McDonald and Emily Dwyer. They'll be taking over the mic and telling you just what is going on down here. As you can see, if you're watching on screen, SBS on demand. SBS themselves have entered into the parade and their float is coming along now. Lots of dancing. Very, very gorgeous. And they've got some rainbow boom mics, believe it or not.
That is the shiniest float I've seen yet. Fuzzy's down there getting amongst the dancers. SBS is having an absolute blast.
They are indeed. Well, thank you so much for watching.
Yeah, this has been a lot of fun, Adam. Oh, it's time to get amongst it. It's time for us to have a little bit of a dance, I think.
This is Adam Richard and Greta Larkins. We will have to leave you here in just a moment. But, yeah, if you haven't seen any of the footage yet, if you're only listening on the radio, jump on your computer and have a look at Mardi Gras website or the SBS website.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Chapel Street is bringing the party to the back streets as part of Melbourne Food and Wine Festival. Grab your friends and join us for a Sunday session in celebration of Melbourne's best urban street food with party vibe tunes, street art, circus arts and hip hops and drops. This free event, proudly supported by Deliveroo, takes place on Sunday, March 6th from 1 till 9pm in the Artist's Lane between Green and Union Streets. Then kick on after the party from 8 till late at Hoo Ha. For full lineup, visit chapelstreet.com.au. The Windsor & Co. Block Party, presented by the Chapel Street Precinct, a Joy sponsor.
From the outrageously adorned to the sassy, satirical and serious, SBS is showcasing the truly incredible 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Hosted by Patrick Abood, Faustina Agoli, Tom Ballard and Magda Szybanski. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Tomorrow 8:30 on SBS. Reflecting diversity.
Joy sponsor.
Luke, I am your father's new boyfriend. We met online 6 months ago. We share many common interests, like pottery, and he's very supportive of my work and ambitions. He's the stars to my galaxy.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
Luke, I am your father's new boyfriend. We met online 6 months ago. We share many common interests, like pottery, and he's very supportive of my work and ambitions. He's the stars to my galaxy.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
HangMyTV.com.au. HangMyTV. That's what we do.
Now you can finally get your TV hung and mounted safely with HangMyTV.com.au. Because that's what we do. Get more space and create a cinema-style experience. Call 1-300-HANG-MY-TV today. HangMyTV.com.au. Because that's what we do.
HangMyTV.com.au. HangMyTV. That's what we do.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Square in Sydney, broadcasting with live streaming online from the Mardi Gras website and SBS online, plus on air on SBS Digital Radio 3, Joy 94.9 in Melbourne, and the community radio network around Australia. Welcome.
Hello
Matt
Australia.
Again.
Happy Mardi Gras, Australia. This is so exciting. We're into the multicultural section of the parade now. Emily, with floats from all over the world. We've just had the Brazilians come through with their Latin beats. And it looks like we've got Siam now.
Siam Australia Thai Community, a group of Australian and Thai people who support and assist the Thai community in Australia for inclusion and acceptance.
They've got those very distinctive, very tall parasol type umbrellas as a part of
which aren't really of very much use at the moment.
And it's a good thing.
Maybe it's a great barrier against the tons of glitter which is coming down on everyone.
Glitterbrellas.
There is a gorgeous, gorgeous breeze. It's blowing the glitter everywhere. And looking around, I'm looking up behind us, there are people on the balconies, rainbow flags, waving, cheering, and people across the road waving, cheering.
And the energy hasn't died down. We're, 2 hours into the parade, and everybody is still pumped, they're still cheering, and there's still lots of glitter.
Angel Shanghai coming through Taylor Square.
So this is actually a Chinese group from Shanghai. It's the biggest group that's been a part of this event here. Great to see the Chinese community a part of Mardi Gras here in Sydney.
And telling us that, not letting us know that Shanghai is a gay-friendly city, so if you are LGBTIQ, you can have great fun in Shanghai.
It's one of those countries that seems to be giving hints that they're going to be more and more accepting, so some exciting things on the horizon for China.
Tied Together and the Thai Ladyboy Superstars are the next groups up in Sydney's Mardi Gras.
And Aussies love Thailand. You've got to say, a mecca for tourism. And when you see the beautiful costumes that are just stunning, the amount of detail that's in the costumes of Ladyboy Superstars down there on the all different colours, feathers galore, glitter galore, of course.
So along with Tied Together, they love being part of the parade and are showing us that right here in all the glorious colours and feathers. And their message is that they're proud to be transgender and gay and promoting acceptance and equality for all. And we all love that.
Now, Emily, for you, how important is it to see a profile for the transgender community in an event such as this?
I think all the way through the parade, I've been looking for trans visibility, and I think we've seen it with the Greens, we've seen it with a number of the youth and student groups. I think with Thai Ladyboy, it's one of those phrases which is interesting. You've got to be... It's sort of a question of who can say it, because there is a certain degree of acceptance of trans people, ladyboys in Thailand, but within certain parts of society. And so there's still a long way to go in Thailand, as with everywhere else, in terms of a genuine equality and inclusion in all aspects of life.
Not full acceptance. More to be achieved, and momentum is what will get us there, and that's the theme of Mardi Gras 2016, Momentum Stronger Together. There's quite a contingent supporting the ladyboys as well, all dressed up in their nice, their very flashy vests.
Yes. Love the headdresses.
They
and
are
the flowy bits.
I don't know how they
all the soft bits. I'd like
so
to run
steadily.
My fingers. I'd like to run my fingers through those soft feathery bits.
And they're able to dance with them on. I don't know how they quite do that. They've just got such a steady walk and doing a fantastic job.
The Asian marching boys and friends are joining us. Thank you for joining us. This marching group aims to promote the visibility and acceptance of gay Asian men in Australia. And one of the groups here, I guess as we're going through this multicultural part of the parade, that encourages us to recognise and celebrate the ethnic diversity of our LGBTIQ community in Australia, to recognise that there is racism in our community, as there is in the broader community, and this is an opportunity for us to celebrate everyone who's part of it.
And the Asian marching boys are pretty much every year one of the biggest marching groups in the Mardi Gras. Their theme this year, they are a golden army representing a golden era, because this is their 20th year of marching, the Asian marching boys.
Drawing on the curse of the golden flower, which symbolises strength in numbers, passion, longevity and the struggle for equality. And passion and longevity, that's something that people will be looking for later on tonight, I imagine.
Yeah, about 4 o'clock in the morning at the parties?
Yeah, for sure.
and that equality theme running right throughout the so many floats here at Mardi Gras 2016.
A little bit of a break in floats coming through. Conchita, do you see Conchita was down in the VIP area a little bit earlier?
I didn't. I missed her. But she's also performing at the after party as well.
Absolutely. Woo! Oh, dear. There's been a fall. Someone with an amazingly large boa headdress, and they're up on their feet.
And a huge, huge cheer of support for the crowd. We should point out that the participants started marshalling about 5.30 or 6 o'clock tonight, so they've already been, waiting to be a part of this for 4 hours now. And then they're walking up a really long hill, which is Oxford Street, and that's only the halfway point. They then go from here all the way towards the showground. So they will be feeling it right now.
And then they'll need plenty of energy after that too, I imagine.
Exactly.
Some of them wearing high heels, walking all the way up Oxford Street with that much weight on your head. I salute you.
It's a gift, I think.
Sweeties of the Sea from Little Conwong. Tell us about that one, Matt.
Now, these are the longest continuous Mardi Gras float. They have participated for 27 years, since 1989. Participated continuously. And they're a group of both LGBTI and their friends who have fun and support each other. And they think it takes courage for everybody to be who they are and look after themselves. So they're on a path of courage, bravery and friendship.
You're listening to live coverage of Sydney's Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras, broadcasting on the Mardi Gras website, SBS Online, plus on air on SBS Digital Radio 3, Joy 94.9 in Melbourne, and community radio stations around Australia via the Community Radio Network. Wherever you're listening, welcome. We hope you're having a wonderful, wonderful time with us here at this year's Mardi Gras.
And we should give a big shout out to any of the community radio stations picking us up in the country, the regional areas, so that this parade reaches all around Australia.
Scots boys are out and they're proud, but they haven't forgotten where they came from. They're showing us a lot, aren't they?
So this is the Scottish contingent. There are kilts galore. And headbands. Our headbands are very Scottish.
And they're blowing their pipes. Could mean many things.
They are.
Scots in their kilts with bagpipes. Coming up Oxford
Street.
They've
had a pipe band with them.
Coming up Oxford Street, a giant cockpit.
A giant what?
It's the Qantas float.
The Qantas float.
Champions of the spirit of diversity, fueled by passion, one of Mardi Gras' official sponsors. So fasten your seatbelts and get ready to take off. So we can see the cockpit part of it. Is there a tail?
And leading
Courtney
that
float,
it is a Courtney Act.
I can't see her. It's coming around the corner.
She's...
Oh, they're out. Oh, hello. We're well, getting a massive, massive, massive global, wave from the crowd.
Global ambassador for Mardi Gras. And all the Qantas crew are getting a very big crowd. They've got their...
So Courtney's a pilot, which will help her get a right swipe on Grindr. I'm told that that's if you're a pilot, that's how you get a right swipe.
Right. Well, you say you're a pilot. So they've got their glow sticks, those sticks that they guide the plane in. They're waving them around. This is one of those floats that would have taken a long time to choreograph and get this. Probably, I'd say there's a couple of hundred people down there twirling their glow sticks.
And masses and masses and masses of rainbow glitter covering the cockpit of the Qantas A380. I'd like to see a plane flying around in colours like that.
I think so.
Spraying glitter around the world. You have like these great big glitter tanks on the aeroplane.
So when you see that streak across the sky, it would actually be rainbow. Wow, I like it. We'll workshop it. We'll take it to...
there's an idea for the Qantas people. And the big tail.
It is.
Coming
it's
through
one of the
Taylor
longest
Square.
Floats here in the parade. phrase, Happy Mardi Gras. It's been going on all afternoon. The shops are full, the streets are full, and we're here at Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Some more pipers coming.
You can't have too many bagpipes. Apparently.
They're doing the whole Braveheart thing here. It's the Scottish contingent with waving their flags. The parade is moving a lot faster. We're trying to get some ringside interviews as well for you, and they're flying by. I think everybody's sensing that the party is very, very close.
Now, if you can hear some drumming, which I can, we have the dancing and the drumming group. Compasso Rumbe, believing everyone deserves the same rights, and that through dance and drumming, we're all united. We support marriage equality and the right to be who you want to be. Well, we love you for that.
And wow, haven't they actually got the most extravagant costumes? I'm not quite sure it's feathers or balloons running out of their back. No, it is feathers. They are shimmering and shaking their booties, which is another gift that I don't have, shaking their booties all the way up the street.
There are all kinds of different drums and drummers.
And
we all march to a different drum.
We do, and they are marching to all sorts of drums. The music has definitely been pumped up with all these salsa beats.
And when you're a drummer, you can wear whatever you want. There are drummers wearing lots of... drummers wearing very little.
And the float in big letters is Pride.
So these are the balloon artists.
Oh, here's the balloon artist.
And
this fascinated me.
The things you can do with some rubber. There are.
It's a sea of balloons. It's like spaghetti.
There's a sea of rubber in front of us. Big balloons, little balloons. They've got people made out of combinations of balloons, long balloons.
And I think we've got somebody down on the street crossing down.
That's right, I'm here, and Scott here, and who am I with?
My name's Nicole, we're from Compasso Urumbe.
So tell us about your marching with your little one tonight.
Yes, we're supporting the Uruguayan lesbian and gay community.
And how many times have you been marching?
This is my second and third.
Awesome, well, have a lovely Mardi Gras.
Thank you, you too.
Back to you guys.
Thanks, Scott. This is wonderful. You've got people who are in their first Mardi Gras, people in their second Mardi Gras. There are people who've been here in 27, or probably 10, 15, 20 Mardi Gras.
And I think that's one of the things. Mardi Gras is such an intensely personal thing. Everybody has a story. Everybody has a memory. And it keeps people coming back and sharing those stories, sharing what it is to be gay in Australia.
And some people who, I guess, came out a long time ago, who reminiscing and thinking about all the things that have changed. And some people who are just on this journey. I think all those multicultural floats we've seen are a great reminder that the rights and the freedom of expression that some of this experience is not universal across all parts of the Australian community. It's wonderful to see people at their first Mardi Gras and people at their 20th Mardi Gras.
And this group here is in their 25th Mardi Gras. This is the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Choir. They're not singing tonight because they're too busy dancing in silver lame capes.
I hope they're going to stop and do a bit of a number for us. The Gay and Lesbian Choir is in their 25th Mardi Gras. Parade is one of the highlights of their calendar.
They've
got a specially mixed music track. And some, amazing costumes and choreography.
You'd love to see them come together with a bank of microphones and break into song, wouldn't you?
I think they're one of those groups that are a part of so many of the community events, whether it's Mardi Gras or so many other occasions during the year, that just bring us together, sing, make us feel awesome. And also part of that kind of cultural memory of Mardi Gras and our community.
It's also a great way to meet people. I guess there's a lot of people when they're first coming out, they don't know many people. Getting involved in a social group like that where you can sing, you don't even have to be, you don't have to be going on Australian Idol or anything. and you can join this group, meet some friends, and learn a new skill.
Well, it sounds like maybe you don't need to sing. That's a great one for me.
Coming up, this is Merlin's Magic Wand. Now, this is a group. They also, they have 13 attractions all over Australia, including Madame Tussauds, and they've got some of the pieces from Madame Tussauds as a part of their float.
We're in a musical phase of the Mardi Gras, and the street team has booked someone from the choir. Over to you.
Hi, it's Grace here. Who do I have here?
I'm Matthew from the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Choir.
And how's your Mardi Gras going, Matthew?
Fabulous. It always is, but I think this year even more so.
And how many years have you marched?
I haven't marched every year, but I joined in 1994, so I've been 20 years now.
Wow, a long time. And how long does this outfit take to prepare?
It takes a lot of work.
Well, you look fabulous. You have a lovely night. Happy Mardi Gras.
Thank you, darling. Thank you.
And back to you guys.
Wow, 20 Mardi Gras. Amazing. Now, the Sydney Homotones also passing by. Part of the musical contingent of the Mardi Gras parade. The Sydney Homotones, the city's premier LGBTQ community band. Membership's open to anyone. Anyone who plays a concert instrument, regardless of your sexual orientation, or I guess gender orientation as well.
They can root and toot like no one else.
Did someone say Samantha Jade? I'm craning my neck around. Where? On the TV screen! It's a float.
And she's a part of a float for The Star, the casino here in Sydney. And they are an official supporter of Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. She's belting out a tune too.
In a gorgeous, gorgeous red sequined little number. Lovely boots. Couldn't quite do those boots myself.
I'd give it a go. You can only fall down. A great contingent of staff from the casino in there behind her as well, waving their glittery signs.
The People's Republic of Mardi Gras.
Oh, now this is one of the award-winning ones.
Absolutely. The Pink Army returns to continue the battle against homophobia. They say they're a mix of LGBTIQs and threats who unite to deliver our message against bigotry through our army of pink soldiers who dance in unison.
So this group actually just gets together for Mardi Gras. They don't do anything else. They just come together, gay, straight, whoever, come along, be a part, and they come up with a different theme each year.
But if you're going to have a People's Republic of Mardi Gras sounds like a lovely idea.
It does. Vote one, People's Republic.
And congratulations to them for all of their awards.
They've actually got a fire-breathing dragon.
Well, it's breathing something. It's breathing something white. Whatever that is. It's Kath and Jen's magnificent momentum machine. Momentum being the theme of this year's Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
These girls call themselves Lesbian Imagineers.
Representing a steampunk contraption for our edification and entertainment. It's got plenty of sparkle, some spinning bits and lots of knobs, apparently.
They're out to bedazzle us. Bedazzle us with their glittering shine.
Apparently, this is great, it's an exact mechanical replication of our politicians' approach to federal anti-discrimination legislation and same-sex marriage legislation. Just get it together, everyone. Already,
so
get it together
noise.
Already.
It looks good, but it's not going anywhere. That's their message. Oh,
Gadiators are gay.
Gadiators.
Gay, proud, and violently sexy in the name of Rome, but with a Spanish flavour. So there's something for just about everyone there.
You don't know any Spanish gladiators, do you? Or gay
Spanish Roman gladiators who are violently sexy.
And they've got those nice little leather outfits.
The little strappy bits all the way up their legs. And I love that.
Weapons. One girl there, I think she's been inspired by Xena, warrior princess.
Brandishing their shields. Lovely headgear.
Ooh. Now some of them have chosen the traditional Roman gladiator sandals and others are in high heels. I know which one would be easier. This is Gadiators at the Sydney Gate Lesbian Mardi Gras.
You're listening to coverage of the Mardi Gras. You could be listening via the Mardi Gras website, SBS Online, SBS Digital Radio 3, Joy 94.9 in Melbourne, or community radio stations around Australia, thanks to the Community Radio Network.
And so much happening. This is our biggest ever broadcast here at Mardi Gras.
174 floats, I think. Massive.
Wow.
Display of community pride and a whole range of organisations that support us.
Now this float picks up on, this float's picking up on Game of Thrones, but might see what's happening on the street.
Hey guys, it's Josh. Now who do I have here?
You've got Leanne from Game of Thrones.
Fantastic. Now what does Mardi Gras mean to you?
It means absolutely fantastic opportunity for everybody in the world to come out and be who the fuck they want to be.
Fantastic. You look absolutely incredible. You look absolutely incredible.
I have to run for my flow.
No worries. Have a fantastic Mardi Gras.
Love your radio station.
Thanks, guys. Back to you.
Oh, we love that everybody put so much into their preparations for this event.
The Dreamwalkers. Oh, chasing our wildest dreams. What's your wildest dream, Matt?
What's my wildest dream? Oh, I don't know. Probably to be on top of that float wearing a skimpy outfit and a tail.
I'd love to see that. I'm saying next year, Mardi Gras, back to the street.
Hey, it's Dylan down here, and I'm with a bride and a groom. Now, do you want to introduce yourselves for?
Mitch
and. And tell me, why are we in the wedding garb tonight? Any particular reason?
I think we have to do marriage equality theme, and we're with the dream walkers who are dreaming about marriage equality.
We can't literally get married, so might as well do it where we can.
Absolutely. Now, you two look phenomenal. I'm so happy that you were having a chat with me tonight. What's going on for you for the rest of the evening?
Not really much planned at the moment. Just going to see when the night takes us.
We will wait till the march ends, and then we will decide about it. I think we're going to go to after party. I don't know about it yet.
Well, hopefully I might see you there. Oh, my God, it's getting crazy down here yet again. Please, please, what's going on upstairs?
Emily, I'm just picturing Dylan there as their marriage celebrant. He's got this big mohawk, glitter-filled mohawk happening. You know, dearly beloved, we are gathered here.
We're making plenty of people's dreams come true tonight.
We've got Free, Gay and Happy with us right now. More than 500 members. They're holding social events, book clubs and looking after, raising funds for local charities. This year's theme is Heavenly Encounters.
There's some very, very, very fancy women coming through. And some gorgeous, gorgeous ball gowns. Royalty, in fact.
Indeed, with lovely purple hair. They're getting a huge wave from the crowd. Nobody's left here. The crowds are still 20 deep up here at Taylor Square in Sydney.
The Glamazon All-Stars, I believe, are coming up the road. Music is certainly ramping up.
It is. The excitement is building as they head across to the Mardi Gras after party. We've got some more glittering lame shorts coming. More short shorts. I tell you, there's none left. There's none left.
The Glamazon Cadet Corps united this year to bring truth, justice and hope to our world. That's three good things. We made three good choices.
Let's find out what's happening down on the street. No, we've lost our street team. Guys on the street, how's our street team holding up?
Can you hear me? We are on the street here and there is so much glitter going on down here. So many fabulous costumes. You can see all the effort that these guys are putting in this year. This is an amazing Mardi Gras tonight.
What's been your highlight?
It's such a party atmosphere.
It is a huge party atmosphere down here. It's just phenomenal. And who do I have here?
Hello, guys. I'm sorry. I couldn't understand your question.
What's been your highlight?
What is your name?
Benjamin.
And where are you from, Benjamin?
The Sydney boy.
And what's your pride march today?
We're the Glamazon All-Stars. We're the cadets this year. We are marching forward in blue and gold.
And there are so many of you and you all look fabulous. Are you having an amazing night?
We always do. Even though it's late, we always have an amazing night.
And what does Mardi Gras mean to you guys?
I think we have to remember everybody that's come before us to set this up while I can live my life a safe and happy gay man in this city.
Exactly, and you look fabulous. You have a lovely night. Happy Mardi Gras.
You guys.
And back to you guys up there.
Now, Emily, I've just seen the two most glamorous toilet rolls I've ever seen in my life. And I'm very serious. So this is Filma Box and Art Simon. Filma's a well-known drag queen up here in Sydney. And this is their 20th anniversary. And the first time they came in this 20 years ago, they were dressed in the same style of outfit, the toilet roll. But they've really dressed it up here tonight. Fully silver glitter. There's flashing lights in their hair. And they are twirling their way right around Taylor Square.
So well known, and this year bringing us a Roman orgy.
It's a Roman orgy.
It's togas.
We like a good toga.
It's togas, it's gold glitter paint, it's and lots of really, 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 really tiny white shorts. Tiny shorts has been our thing.
Now they have the slaves that are pulling along the float, the Roman-inspired float. They're pretty buffed-up slaves, I have to say. They're feeding those slaves very well and doing lots of working out at the slave gym, I think.
Matt, it's been wonderful to bring more of Sydney's Mardi Gras. Whether you're listening on SBS 94.9 Community Radio around the country, thanks for being with us.
Happy Mardi Gras, everybody!
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
Luke, I am your father. New boyfriend. We met online 6 months ago. We share many common interests, like pottery, and he's very supportive of my work and ambitions. He's the stars to my galaxy.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
No matter who takes you home on your weekdays, you won't be left disappointed.
I love being taken home by Jax and Greta.
I never miss Chris and Cap.
You gotta love David and Sue.
Lulu and Michael, what a scream.
Oh, Dano and Mason. Now that's a new way to be taken home.
Let Joy take you home. 4 to 7 on weekdays. With thanks to Diversity Expo, the largest LGBTI exhibition heading to Melbourne's Convention and Exhibition Centre April 16 and 17. Diversityexpos.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
This summer, heat things up at Australia's largest and cruisiest gay and bisexual sauna, Wet on Wellington. Open from midday till late during the week and 24 hours over the weekend. Featuring some of the sexiest theme nights in town, like Under 30s Night, Nude Night, Swingers Night and more. With Friday night happy hours and special extra long pass out. Enjoy the licensed bar and cafe, 20-person spa and a range of special attractions. Wet on Wellington, the hottest place to cruise and meet this summer. For more details, check out wetonwellington.com.au. Joy sponsor.
It's the hottest theatre show on the planet and it's coming to Melbourne. Velvet, the disco, circus, burlesque extravaganza. It's raining men. With a star-studded cast, including the legendary diva, Marsha Hines. Playing at the Cooper's Malt House for a limited season only. Opens March 23. Book your tickets now. Velvet. Welcome to Wonderland. Boogie Wonderland. Joy sponsor.
Luke, I am your father's new boyfriend. We met online 6 months ago. We share many common interests, like pottery. And he's very supportive of my work and ambitions. He's the stars to my galaxy.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
We are at
Taylor Square for the very end of the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras 2016. Dean Beck with you. Shannon Power joins me for this wonderful live streaming broadcast on Mardi Gras website and on SBS online website as well.
Thank you very much, Dean Beck. And I can't believe we got to number 162 out of 175 before we heard some Beyonce. Now I'm seeing some Beyonce on the run tour inspired outfits. I'm hearing some Run the World girls. And as the former host of the Chappelle Show, I used to do my Beyonce prayer every week on the show. It makes me so happy to hear Beyonce because I still love her to this day. Even though I'm not on tour anymore, I'm happy.
Well, I think it's time to get a little more grounded, so let's go down to the pit crew. Who've we got down there?
Hey, well, we're chilling out here right now, and I've got Josh, who's been out here with the broadcast all night. I want to know, Josh, what has Pride and Mardi Gras meant for you?
Honestly, it's... it's about equality, it's about being who you are and representing your community as one.
And I understand this is your very first Mardi Gras as well.
It definitely is, and I'm having the absolute time of my life. I have never experienced anything like it. I am honestly so proud to be who I am, and I know all my friends, all my family will definitely say the same.
And Josh, I just want to say, you know, I used to be the young person at Joy, and now, you know, you've come along and taken my ranks. But I want to say it's so amazing that we were able to be on a radio station where we can, you know, celebrate youth culture and be able to give you a platform to be able to broadcast here from Mardi Gras.
120%. I have to say Joy has changed my life for the better. A lot of different stories I could tell you. I'm so happy to be part of a family like Joy.
Oh, we love that you're part of our family as well, Josh. Now, just quickly, I would like to say thank you to everyone that we've seen so far today. What's going on upstairs?
Well, thank you very much, Dylan, and thank you, Josh. Now, we are up to the Oz Fag Hacks going past. They are all flavours of the rainbow, Shannon Power.
Why do you look at me when you say Oz Fag Hacks, D-Mac?
I think licorice all sorts. I think Shannon Power, Fag Hacks.
I think all colours of the rainbow. And it's good to see Oz Fag Hacks, who are a group of girls who transgress the boundaries between gay and straight culture and unsettled identity politics. Yes, to
bring
fluidity.
Yes, right. So we're going to go down to gender and path. No, that's not good. So, a very colourful bunch or an eclectic bunch. Can we say that?
Eclectic. I mean, I think that's what Sydney Pride, if anything we've learnt tonight, is this community. It's diverse, it's eclectic, it's...
colourful and sparkly, I'd say.
At the very least.
At the very least. And there's only a few more quotes to go for the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. It's sort of winding up before it ends up. Oh, I've got breaking news.
Shut up, tell me. Everyone shush, listen. What does Dean Beck have to say?
Tonight's Mardi Gras party has sold out. You cannot get a ticket at the door for love or money. It is chock-a-block.
And that's probably because Conchita Verse, Courtney Axe is performing with 50 drag queens at 1:30 a.m. That's probably why.
Deborah Cox is there, Tracy Young is there.
Heaps of people.
Lighting is being done tonight in the RHI by Alan Parkinson, who's been doing it for many, many, many years.
So, Dean Beck, in your about 55 years of coming to Sydney Mardi Gras,
yes.
Oh, it's only been going for 38 years, how many years you've been coming along, how does tonight compare to other Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras parades that you've been involved in?
Glitter is the thing that I will take away from this. There's been more glitter cannons than I've ever seen before.
Are you for real?
Yeah, I think it's the right amount of wind. It's the right amount of wind to fly the flag. It's the right amount of wind to blow glitter cannons right across
the
stage.
I just want to share with the audience listening on Joy 94.9, streaming live by the web stream on mardigras.org.au and on SBS Digital Radio 3. Dean Beck and I had a beautiful moment before when one of the floats shot a massive pink glitter stream, and the wind blew it straight into the rainbow flag over Taylor Square. We both looked up and were like, this is what tonight is about. It's about glitter, it's about rainbow, it's about family, it's about community. We've had a fantastic night here at the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. I'm very happy to be involved in my first one. It's been a phenomenal evening. We're not quite done yet. I don't want people to think that we don't have another five or six floats to go.
No. And there's the hashtag for Ruby Rose, which
gay for Ruby Rose. People love her. She's great. From what I understand, is because she's gender fluid, she's a proud lesbian, people love her. And she was, of course, on Orange is the New Black. She hosted the MTV European Music Awards.
So we're using the word gay in that context as an all-inclusive term, or as
no, it's a new thing. I think maybe being in the older generation, Dean Beck, now when you say you're gay for something, it means you really, really love it. So, like, I'm gay for you, Dean Beck, even though, like, me and you would never, like, be gay that way together. I'm gay for you because I love you so much.
I'm still trying to work out whether gay is the bad thing or the good thing.
It's great, mate. It's great to be gay. I think that's the whole point of Pride March.
It's Mardi Gras too, and that is why we are celebrating the one of the world's biggest celebrations of gay pride here at Mardi Gras 2016. Now, we are looking forward to the party. It's going to be a huge event. But right now, going past us, we have underwear models and bubbles and confetti.
This scantily clad people, more which confetti. Is a shock horror at the more Sydney confetti. Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
And they've got fantastic mohawks in feathered mohawk designs and headdresses that look absolutely sensational.
They are a great group, and they are for the love of sequins, I believe. I might be wrong.
To
give people an idea of what we're seeing, there's a truck with a frame and two huge black mannequins. And it's a jungle theme with people doing handstands and flips off the railings. And it's quite outrageous.
They've got these fog machines spurting out over the entire crowd. Now, go down to what is happening, they're being spurted.
I am standing here with Kevin, who is sporting quite the mohawk. It's giving me quite a run for my money. Kevin, who are you marching with?
Sorry?
Who are you marching with?
I'm marching with Trishy and the Heart Candy Float in support of Beyond Blue.
In support of Beyond Blue. So is mental illness and within the LGBTI community, is mental illness something that you guys help to fight, I guess?
I mean, I guess it's definitely something that I personally do. Coming from an upbringing where I was bullied and have been depressed for a long time, you know, anything that I can do to reach out and raise some money for a good cause is something I won't take a second chance at.
Well, Kevin, you have no reason to be depressed tonight. You are phenomenal. You stay excellent, man. Oh, Chappelle, I think I just met my husband.
Thank you very much for that, Dylan. The Hot Candy Group are the last official entry in the Sydney Gay Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade for 2016.
Correct, and we need to do a massive shout out to our street team of Dylan, Scott, Grace, and Josh.
Thank you very much to all the crew down there. And there's this tradition here at Mardi Gras where they come through and they take over at the end. The cleanup crew.
Oh.
As you can hear,
but they're carrying drums. How do they clean up when they've still got drums? And they've got like a sort of Trojan horse unicorn with a light.
It's a weird thing they do at the end of every Mardi Gras. This year, a Trojan horse unicorn is now in the centre of Taylor Square being fanfared.
It's got a rainbow heart.
And there's
going
to be a dance routine.
Pumping.
Here we go.
Out of it. All right, so just to describe to the people who may be listening who aren't watching the live stream on mardigras.org.au, there's a Trojan horse unicorn with a beating rainbow heart coming out of it. And a heap of people dressed up, I guess, in a Roman glitter unicorn theme with the drums. They're dancing. It's coordinated.
There are over 200 people in a choreographed dance right in the heart of Taylor Square as we speak, with a unicorn nodding its head up and down.
I mean, it's not Mardi Gras if you don't have a bedazzled unicorn. Am I right, Dean Beck?
Indeed. And that's the music that you're hearing is what they're dancing to.
So there's some women also I can see in glitter suits who are on stilts. So they've waited since 2 p.m. to come out to Taylor Square tonight at about 21 minutes to 11. They've been in those stilts presumably for hours, but they are giving it their everything, dancing here.
That, ladies and gentlemen, was the finale of the 2016 Sydney Gay Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. As the flames go shooting through the sky, these coloured rainbow flames and fireworks just shoot out of the top of Kids Summer Nightclub.
It is a little bit scary, but we're right near the fireworks. They're shooting up. The rainbow flames are coming out of Taylor Square. And people are dancing. They're clapping in the streets.
Now everybody's dancing. Literally everybody. There are hundreds of thousands. people jumping up and down. This Mardi Gras concludes for 2016. Let's see if we've got someone down on the ground there in the pit crew.
Hello, what's going on down here? We got lost in the rhythm of dancing, didn't we? Scotty, I've got quite out of breath. How has your Mardi Gras been?
It's been absolutely amazing. I have to agree with Dean. It's actually been so much glitter, so much sparkle. And look, the fireworks now. Everywhere you go, there's energy.
I just cannot get over how beautiful Sydney has been to us today for the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras.
The weather, every part of today and tonight has been amazing.
Oh, I'm just in such a buzz. I mean, it's so in awe being able to see so many people united as one voice for the LGBTI communities. Wouldn't you agree, Josh?
Oh, absolutely, 120%. Now, what are you up to later on tonight?
Oh, why? What am I up to later? I won't be hitting up any parties. I'll be celebrating with some friends and marching on with our queer pride.
Oh, that sounds...
What about you?
Well, to be honest, I'm going to head to the after party.
Oh, okay, go in my set, Josh. How about you, Chappelle and Dean? What are you two up to a bit later on?
All right, so up here with Dean Beck, Chappelle, who is her first year at the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras, working for Star Observer. My bosses at Star Observer have actually requested that I go to the after party, so I'm going to do my bosses tell me I'm hitting the after party. Dean Beck, what are you up to?
Shannon Power, I don't believe that for a minute, but you sold it well, so very, very well done. You know, last year, our crew was a ticket short, so I gave my ticket to one of our crew so that they could go, because it was their first time. But this year, I'm going to go.
Good on you, Dean Beck. Now, I want to know, there's been 175 floats. It's been a great three-week festival. What's been your highlight of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras?
Well, for me, I reckon it was being present at the media briefing when the police apologised.
Let's be real, you were just kind of lucky to be there because nobody knew.
I didn't know that they were doing that. And I was just there with my reporter and it was a really emotional moment. And I've got to say, it did bring a tear to my eye.
Great.
It was a heartfelt apology. I know not everyone's happy with it. They wanted, some of the 78ers wanted the commission to do it. But I can tell you, in that room, it was very much experienced with a heartfelt apology. It was appreciated.
So we should probably talk a little bit about our broadcast tonight.
We certainly should. You have tonight been listening to Joy 94.9's broadcast done for the very first time live streaming online. And it's been done through Mardi Gras website at mardigras.org.au and at SBS Online at sbs.com.au/Mardi Gras. Keep in mind, tomorrow SBS are going to be playing the Mardi Gras special.
On your television.
On your TV from 8:30 tomorrow night on SBS, Sunday night. Now, we want to thank all of our broadcast team and crew, and we want to say thank you to the Community Radio Network and SBS Digital Radio 3 for also taking our live stream and broadcast tonight. Now, Shannon Power, it has been a delight to spend this very special moment of 2016 with you. It has been a huge event. Thank you, Mullet.
Thank you, Dean Beck. I always love working with you. And the Joy 94.9 team, of course.
And I want to thank our partners. A big thank you to Mardi Gras, who Michelle Bauer from Mardi Gras, who's the new CEO, did a tremendous job at making sure that Joy was accommodated and looked after for this broadcast. It wouldn't have happened without Michael Abid, the CEO of SBS, and his tremendous team at SBS Digital Radio. Thank you very much to them, and also to Martin Walter from the Community Radio Network. We're streaming live around Australia on the Community Radio Network. We thank all of our Community Radio partners for taking our broadcast tonight. This particular broadcast is a technical nightmare, and we have managed to pull most of it off with a fairly smooth operation. So a big thank you to Josh Pearson and his team, Lachlan, Hamish and Nick. And a very big thank you to the man who has done just about more work than anyone, David Moyle, back in our studio. Thank you, David. And Lachlan in the team too. If I missed Lachlan... I thought I did. Thank you. Now, thank you for that. Our social media team, Katie, Leo and the team have been done a tremendous job keeping us at the trending end of the hashtag.
Hashtag Mardi Gras Joy.
A very big thank you to Betty, who does all of our photos, and they have been put through all of our social media so that you can enjoy the colour and movement as we bring you the words. Now to Dan Gregg and to Conrad Brown for audio production, thank you very much for the pre-produced content. It was fantastic. To our parade pit crew, Dylan Adler, Josh Olds, Grace Marshall and Scott Tetley. Thank you for the great work done on
round
the ground.
Round of applause. Fantastic. Who's next?
Our hosts, Matt McDonald, Emily Dwyer, Greta Larkins, Adam Richard and woo! Shannon Power. Thank you very much for your tremendous work here at Mardi Gras 2016. A very big thank you to our broadcast director and executive producer, James Findlay, for making this happen tonight. Thank you, James. And from me, Dean Beck, it has been my absolute pleasure to be with you for this particular Mardi Gras parade. We're going to head off to the party. So until next time, happy Mardi Gras!
Happy Mardi Gras!
This is the live commentary of the 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras Parade. Proudly presented by SBS Radio and Joy 94.9.
We're totally bent for your listening pleasure. Joy 94.9.
I know you're feeling restless, like life's not on your side. It's weighing heavy on your mind. But when we stand united, our hearts, they beat in time.
It's ocean, take this from me tonight. Oh, let's fight. Oh, let's fight. Oh, let's fight. Oh,
radio, online, all the time. Joy 94.9. Fun people, fun shows. Joy 94.9.
Yeah.
perfect mix of music, news and interviews. Joy 94.9.
Are you looking for double the fun, double the action and double the men on the Mornington Peninsula? Then check out the adult entertainment jewel of Seaford, Peninsula Sauna, the hottest place down south for meeting other gay and bisexual guys. Open every day from midday till late with the best place to cruise, relax, meet and play. Featuring two spas, two movie lounges, twice the cruise rooms, dry sauna, steam room and more. With a licensed bar and cafe, masseurs on site, free Wi-Fi and computer use. Check out the special theme nights and more details at peninsulasauna.com.au. Joy sponsor.
I'll be back. So don't even think about checking my grinder.
At the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, we do movies differently. March 31 to April 11. For tickets, visit mqff.com.au.
Joy sponsor.
From the outrageously adorned to the sassy, satirical and serious, SBS is showcasing the truly incredible 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Hosted by Patrick Abood, Faustina Agoli, Tom Ballard and Magda Szybanski. The 2016 Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Tomorrow 8:30 on SBS. Reflecting diversity.
Joy sponsor.
Hi, I'm Hannah. Over 1 million children have been harmed by family violence. 1 in 5 women have suffered from domestic violence. And half of those women will be caring for children, like me.
At Berry Street, we know this is all of our problem. Violence is probably happening to someone in our own street. They're our kids. Please Google Hannah at Berry Street and donate today. It's urgent.
For kids like me.
Joy sponsor.
You're viewing forecast for Melbourne. Today, cool, a top of 22 degrees.
Nice.
Revised forecast. Melbourne, rain, a top of 31 degrees.
What?
Revised forecast. Melbourne, sunny, a top of 39 degrees.
Why, Melbourne? Why?
You can't always rely on the forecast, but you can rely on the Pancake Parlour. When the temperature hits 30 degrees or more this summer, you'll cool down with a free drink at Joy's sponsor, the Pancake Parlour. Yeah, a free drink. A delicious Swiss mountain malt, creamy ice cream soda, lemon iced tea or traditional house-made lemonade. Register now at summerparlour.com.au for your Summer Parlour loyalty card.
Your community is our business. Joy 94.9.
How would you like to join me for a sexy party?
Houston, we have a problem.
Fine.
Oh. If you're gonna save the day, watch out, here I come.
Dex
after dark.
Dex after dark.
Joy 94.9.
Listening to Joy 94.9 and our special Dex After Dark Mardi Gras All Nighter. This hour, the tunes are being spun by DJ Mason Andrews.
Thrill books and others.
latest dance from around the world. Joy 94.9.
After dark.
Joy 94.9.